It's the Llama's Ass. Tonight, guns in America. As another gun-free zone is attacked, reports of armed veterans unable to assist and unarmed veterans fighting back. We're going to discuss how the propagandists fared. Then, Joe Pardini, the MLB playoff pitcher, where it stands, what his predictions are, and where the predictions for the weekend are for the NFL and college football. Plus, hockey started tonight. Might even chime in about that. Go Red Wings. Heather Bumpus joins us in the second hour. She'll be talking about her Halloween special and some of the upcoming paranormal investigations that we have. I know we keep talking about their upcoming. In the next couple of weeks, she's going to be very, very busy. And, of course, Heather's got all that lined out. She'll be in. Then Denny Blaze discusses the political correctness that has infected the Halloween costumes. Yeah, it's finally got to the point where Halloween costumes are now considered offensive. What does that mean for us guys now that our girlfriends and wives won't be dressing up like whores? That'll be in the third hour. Your calls, 1-866-225-5401, 512-632. You're at 512-539-0357. Live tweets at Mike Allen underscore OTA and hashtag that bad boy armed radio. Stick around. I'm Mike Allen. This is the Armed Radio Global Network. And you're on the air.
Route 106 Motors is the home of fine pre-owned vehicles. Experience a no-pressure sale with a family-friendly atmosphere. Route 106 Motors has been practicing the same simple philosophy of low prices for over a decade, and it has brought us great success. Recently, while other dealers are closing their doors, Route 106 Motors is expanding. We are a wholesale dealer, and we own the property and pay cash for all the vehicles. This allows us to sell to the consumer for a lot less than the average dealership. We are a high-volume, small-profit dealer, and we pass the savings on to you. New changes have been made at Route 106 Motors. Stop by and check out our brand-new building. Route 106 Motors, located at 569 West Street. Check our website at Route106Motors.com and be sure to like us on Facebook to find out about all the latest deals and savings opportunities. Route106Motors.com.
Are you ready to take your webpage to the next level? Go to IceGram.com and download for free all the tools you will need to enhance your webpage content for potential customers, clients, or fans. Capture leads, call your audience to action, skyrocket conversation and engagement with action bars, pop-ups, toast notifications, message boxes, overlays, and sidebars. Head on over to IceGram.com for your free download. That's IceGram.com. Bottom line, you'll love it.
Sound microphone muted.
Hey there, all you creepy people. This is Kevin Wayne from Portland, Oregon. You're listening to Armed Radio, home of the big guns.
Are you a gamer? A girl gamer at that? If you're looking for the best hangout point to discuss games, then the right place for you is joystickgirls.com. Meet new gamers, discuss topics, and share hints and tips. Now looking for new members. So sign up today at the new site that keeps getting better and better, joystickgirls.com.
Hey, Joe Rocks, it's Louis Avis straight from Chi-Town. Come on and talk about our website, www.hotsaucevault.com. We got everything you can think of out there, Joe. The hottest hot sauce is not for wimps, mild, medium sauces. We got barbecue sauces, snacks, some of our gift ideas and gag gifts, so you can go out and check us out at www.hotsaucevault.com. Hope to talk to you again on your radio show. Kick-ass show. Had a great time last week. Hope to hear from you soon. Take care, Joe. Hotsaucevault.com.
Hey, everybody, this is Jimmy.
And this is Paul.
We are hosting a new show called Pod Talk. politically offensive talk.
It's going to be about politics, religion, the presidential race, current events.
We're going to have some guests that come on, hopefully Donald Trump himself. Wishful thinking.
No, we're going to have Hillary on.
Yeah, but that would be nice. I'd love to get a hold of Hillary.
I know, I hate fucking that.
So come and join us on Thursday nights at 11 p.m. Eastern, right after Night Talk with Joe Rocks.
Christ almighty, it's like I'm sitting here playing cards with my brother's kids or something. You nerve-wracking sons of bitches.
Welcome back to the show, folks. We're getting started. Actually, we're supposed to be on two platforms. Primecast, if you guys were listening, well, you're not going to be able to hear me anyway. Something's going on with Primecast where it's not picking up my other channels. So if you're listening on Spreaker right now, that's where you're supposed to be, because that's where we're all at, hanging out on Spreaker. Well, what a week we had. I tell you, every time this happens, and it's a tragedy, almost seconds after an event like this happens, and of course I'm talking about the tragedy in Oregon with the school shooting, within minutes after some information about it hits the airwaves, Facebook explodes with all the anti-gunners jumping on there. And basically saying, well, see, this is why we need to get rid of guns. But we don't want to take your guns. We just need to get rid of guns. We need to have better gun legislation. We need to do something. It's taken me a week to talk about this. This happened last week. It's taken me a week to talk about this because I, unlike a lot of the anti-gunners, there's just something wrong about commenting on something when you have very little information. As I watched the story unfold, it became very clear to me that the information that gets pushed out through the media, depending on what media outlet you listen to or watch, falls right in line with whatever the politics of that outlet is. So if it's MSNBC, CNN, of course, they're very liberal slanted. You got Fox News, which is very conservative slanted. It's all propaganda, really. And it's meant to divide us, and I just want to throw that out there. But when you watch CNN, they had up to 20 deaths at one point. Now, this is a couple of hours after the incident. And then, of course, Fox News jumped on it. And Shepard Smith, to his credit, did say, I don't know what's going on. We're waiting for stuff to come in. I don't want to comment, but this is with the information we have so far. And he made it very clear that during the whole unfolding of the information that he did not have all the information and that what he was giving was the information that was given him. To his credit, he's the only news outlet that did that. CNN, MSNBC, Wolf Blitzer, all those guys were like, you know, this has to stop. Of course, President Obama within hours was talking about strict gun legislation. The government needs to do something to protect the people. I tell you what, this is how the government can protect us from school shootings. If every politician up there strapped up and stood in the doorway with a gun, that's how you protect people in a classroom. You don't do it with words on a piece of paper. Now I waited for a while, and I made little comments here and there, just kind of see how things played out. Of course, Fox News did jump on the anti-Christian war against Christians. Early reports came out that he was asking people the religion, and then when they answered that they were Christian, he was shooting them. That ended up being a lie. He asked one person. It came out later through eyewitness reports that one person, he asked one person if they were a Christian. She said yes, and he shot her. So all this is going on, and all this misinformation is jumping around, and all I can do is sit back really and watch. So the facts are this. The guy comes from a family that the mom had a lot of guns, and she was one of the right-wing anti-government type folks. Now this has been unconfirmed that he had mental illness. Of course, he was never diagnosed with mental illness, and up until this incident, never did anything to show up on anybody's radar. And of course, mom and dad are never going to think that their kids have mental illness. So, but everybody's jumping on the well. We need tougher legislation to keep guns out of hands of the people like this. Well, here's my question, and this is yet to be answered, and you can answer it tonight. If anybody's listening, you can answer it tonight. What legislation, what gun law would have prevented, not made it harder, not made it harder for people to get a hold of stuff, not all that stuff, what gun law would have prevented this shooting? Because if you're going to use this shooting as an example of why we need tougher laws, then you need to come up with a law that will specifically stop what happened. Stop this person from going in the classroom. Joining me in the Armed Radio Global Central Texas Man Cave, go ahead and introduce yourself, because you didn't like, and don't use the name that you're not going to be the... ass pounder, whatever the hell you came.
The thing about
introduce yourself.
All right, my name's Alex. I'm Mike's son.
I raised him right. Now, Alex, let me ask you. You grew up in a house full of guns, okay?
I did.
So I'm just going to ask you. And you own guns now?
I do.
A few? You own a few. When I raised you in a house with guns, what did I teach you? You tell me what I taught you.
It goes without saying is that firearms aren't a toy. It's like a tool, and that it's unforgiving if you disrespect it, and that it demands your attention. You know, it demands your common sense. And your respect for it.
So when I raised you, when I brought you up, and you were old enough to realize, what were some of the things that I did specifically that you can remember that taught you that?
That if we were, if we were curious about guns, or if we wanted to look at it or talk about it, that to come and get you, and that you would show us how to properly, well, me and my sister, you'd show us how to properly hand over a firearm to somebody with the breech open and the muzzle clear of, you know, everybody's face and stuff.
Yep.
And, you know, obviously unloaded and with the safety on, you know.
And is every gun loaded?
In this house?
No, is every gun loaded? When you approach a gun.
Oh, always assume that it is loaded.
Always.
And that the safety is off. You know, like I said, it demands your respect.
You know, I went to a gun store down the road here. I was looking for a smaller 1911 model pistol to carry.
Smaller?
Well, you know, smaller than the big old hog leg that I got, because it's kind of hard to hide that thing. But to carry as an off duty, and the guy cleared it, which is a habit, and he handed it to me, closed it, handed it to me butt first, and I opened it and cleared it again, and he got offense to that. He's like, why did you just clear it? You just sat here and watched me clear it. And I had to tell him, anytime you pick up a gun, whether you cleared it 5 minutes ago, you pick it up, you clear it again. You always clear it.
Yeah, I mean, you don't know if he's
always
a magician.
Always clear it.
You could have just like...
But that's just – that. Well, that's what you – that's the habits that you form when you grow up and you learn about firearms. That's it.
Yeah.
Every gun's loaded. And I liked what you said because I forgot that I taught you that guns are to be respected and they're unforgiving. They don't give you a second chance. So you can't treat it like anything other than with the respect that it's earned, that it's a gun.
Mm-hmm.
Now, you survived 18 years in a house full of firearms.
Right.
Did you ever, in those 18 years, fear for your life?
Not at all.
Because guns were in the house.
Yeah.
But there was guns in the house.
Yeah.
I'm told that you growing up had a 50% chance of not surviving your childhood because I had guns in the house.
If we had a pool, would have the same chances of drowning. So that's a stupid.
Well, of course it's stupid. I'm being facetious here.
I know.
Because people are scared. Right now people won't. I mean, they're tweeting all over the place. There's some stuff I just can't read. But they won't call in. Here's the questions I have. One, what law that we don't have already concerning the handling of firearms would have prevented the latest shooting? And no one can answer that question.
Wait, without impeding on, obviously without being...
Well, it's the only people it's going to affect is me.
And yeah.
It's not going to affect anything else. But they use the shooting as a sounding board, and these are the answers I get. It wouldn't stop it, but it would make it more difficult.
Okay.
Concerning magazine limits, it would take you wouldn't be able to shoot as many people with the magazine.
It's not that hard, or doesn't take. All
you have to do is reload. And this was an actual answer I got back from a young lady. Well, while they're reloading, that's when you can run away.
Okay.
I mean, look, it's not the gun. Let me just throw this out there. If you have kids and you have a gun in the house, especially when you have small children between the ages of 2 and 5, which are that age where they start getting into crap, if you're going to take time to put bumpers on your kitchen cabinets so that they don't get into the chemicals that are in there. If you're going to take time to put your razor blades up so your son doesn't go into the bathroom and grab your razors and cut himself, if you're going to take time to put knives away, are you going to tell your kid, don't touch that knife? You might cut yourself.
Or, outlet plugs.
If you don't plug stuff in and put it next to the bathtub. If you're going to take time to do all that, then how about you take the time to put your gun away?
Yeah.
How about you take the time to secure it someplace where they can't get to it? How about you put it someplace that's not obvious? And here's the biggest thing. How about you take your son or your daughter and you sit them down with the gun and you satisfy their curiosity and you teach them? Because what did I teach you about when you go to other people's houses and you found a gun or saw a gun? What were you supposed to do?
Not touch it.
Not touch it and...
I don't remember. I just remember not.
Go tell somebody. Oh. Hey, your gun's out. Go tell an adult, right?
Right. Oh, yeah.
Yeah, but you don't touch it.
No.
See, that's how you were raised.
It's not my property, so.
Yeah. So that's not, and it just boggles my mind that adults cannot grasp the concept of personal responsibility. And so if you hate guns, that's fine. Hate guns. I don't care how you defend your family, to tell you the truth. I know if you're a next-door neighbor of mine and you ever need help, I've got extra. So I'll hand you a couple on the way in the door and we'll handle business. And having a gun doesn't necessarily mean that you are 100% sure that you're going to live through a confrontation.
No, but you have a fighting chance.
But you have a chance.
You're not a statistic.
See, someone could break in. Somebody could break into my house and kill me in my sleep. Of course, I didn't have a chance. And the argument is, well, you didn't have a chance anyway. Why do you need a gun? Well, let's say I heard him coming through the front door.
Like has happened before.
Which has happened before. They kicked in our front door.
Yep.
I like what the cop said when he showed up. He said, those are the luckiest people in Idaho.
Yeah. That was an interesting night.
Yeah, I would have. That would have been. I mean, you had a gun in your room. I had a gun in my bedroom.
We didn't shoot each other.
Of course, you always know what you're shooting at.
Mm-hmm.
You always know your target. I guess the argument to me is. Here's some numbers. 30,000 people get killed a year. With guns, average. And that sounds like a whole lot.
Mm-hmm.
They call it an epidemic, and we're going to cover this and we'll go to a break. They call it an epidemic. They call it out of control. Government has to do something about it because, more and more people are dying of guns. But if you think about it, 30,000 out of 370 million. Is less than 2% of the population?
Yeah, maybe.
Now, there's something that kills upwards to 20 million people a year. It can't be sold to people under the age of 18. It's taxed and controlled by the government. You can't advertise it on TV. And now in some magazines. But it's responsible for 20 million deaths. Now, would that be more of an epidemic than guns, you think?
Yeah, I'd believe so.
Yeah,
by definition.
Yeah, I'm talking about cigarettes.
Yeah, I got it.
I'm Mike Allen. This is the Armed Radio Global Network. We'll be right back.
Is your wife wicked hot? Or is she just cold? Do you just want to take a hot shower? Call Savino Mechanical for all your heating, hot water, and cooling needs. Savino Mechanical has been servicing Greater Boston and Southern New Hampshire for over a quarter century. Quality 24-hour service, reasonable rates, satisfaction guaranteed, licensed and insured. And remember, at Savino Mechanical, we are not comfortable until you are. Call Savino Mechanical today at 1-855-624-4280. That's 1-855-624-4280. Savino Mechanical.
Tune in every Monday and Friday night, 10 p.m. Eastern Time, for Straight Talk with Matt Haisley. Live audio on TuneIn Radio and Spreaker.com. Plus live video on Ustream.tv. From the demented minds at ArmedRadioGlobal.com.
Crown Military Miniatures celebrates this holiday season with an enormous selection of new and vintage collector quality toy soldiers. You have to see the photorealistic detail on the World War II armor or the sheer volume of the figures from the American Civil War to the Zulu Wars to the Jacobite Rebellion. If soldiers were there, Crown Military Miniatures has it covered in little men cast in pewter. Veterans, active duty personnel, and military enthusiasts, you have to check out Crown Military Miniatures. Visit them online at crowntoysoldiers.com or visit their store at 88 North Broadway in tax-free Salem, New Hampshire.
Hey,
Joe Rocks. It's Louis Avis straight from Chi-Town. Come on and talk about our website, www.hotsaucevault.com. We got everything you can think of out there, Joe. The hottest hot sauce is not for wimps, mild, medium sauces. We got barbecue sauces, snacks, some of our gift ideas and gag gifts, so you can go out and check us out at www.hotsaucevault.com. Hope to talk to you again on your radio show. Kick-ass show. Had a great time last week. Hope to hear from you soon. Take care, Joe. HotSauceVault.com.
Hi. Now, I know you hear Joe Rocks on their weekly restaurant reviews on Night Talk, 10 p.m. Eastern. And boy, these two like to eat. Right, boys? Well, here's something to review right from your house. Eat24. That's right, eat24.com. With over 25,000 restaurants for you to choose from when you're hungry. Many in your area. So review that, boys. Eat24.com. Click, order, and eat. Eat24.com.
Are you a gamer? A girl gamer at that? If you're looking for the best hangout point to discuss games, then the right place for you is joystickgirls.com. Meet new gamers, discuss topics, and share hints and tips. Now looking for new members. So sign up today at the new site that keeps getting better and better, joystickgirls.com.
Tune in every Monday and Friday night, 10 p.m. Eastern Time, for Straight Talk with Matt Haisley. Live audio on TuneIn Radio and Spreaker.com. Plus, live video on Ustream.tv. From the demented minds at ArmedRadioGlobal.com.
Nothing like talking about gun control and your bumper music's ABBA. That's how I freaking roll. Tonight's broadcast brought to you by HotSauceVault.com. Go to HotSauceVault. I forgot to mention these guys in the first segment, and I do apologize. This place is awesome. If you like hot sauce, like I like hot sauce, they have a wide variety. You can get in there and get lost and spend a whole lot of money. HotSauceVault.com, proud sponsors of Armed Radio. Also, Eat24.com. Download the app on your iTunes or Google Play. Put it in your phone. Put in the zip code of where you're at. They will find a restaurant near you that will deliver food to you. It's kind of handy when you're out of town on a business trip, sitting in that conference room. Everybody else is trying to find out where to go to eat. During that short 30 minutes that they give you, to go eat, but then no worries, because you're already, you know, between checking out Facebook and tweeting and Snapchatting while you're supposed to be paying attention. You can go to eat24.com, put in your zip code, they'll find a restaurant near you, and while everybody else is running out to eat, your food, it's running in. It's like having a food truck in your pants. eat24.com. Welcome back to the show. Joining me in the ring, are joining me in the Armed Radio Global Central Texas Man Cave, my son, the fruit of my loins, fellow bearded man.
Nobody wants to hear about your loins, right?
Alex, we're talking gun control, and we just had a conversation going into the break about mental health and how no one wants to talk about it, and they really don't. I mean, in the late 70s, a lot of those mental institutions needed to be revamped, but they didn't need to be shut down completely. We have a lot of veterans coming back from overseas, going into combat. Combat vet myself, I can attest that, you know, that's a pretty intense situation, and I was only in it for less than a day. I mean, my war was very violent. It was extremely loud, and we won, and it was over. Now, these guys, imagine all my fellow Gulf War vets from 91 having to do that for an entire year. And after a while, you know, it just wears you down. It wears you down. And you get to the point where, your body gets in tune to that high level of alertness and stress and just knowing that at any second you could lose your life and you watch your friends die and then you watch your basic training buddies die or maybe a sergeant that you know die. And it's amazing what we ask our volunteers to do for little or no money. And what's even more amazing to me is after they go and fight these wars in countries where people don't even like us, that won't even fight for their own country, and they come back and they're battle scarred and they're hurting, that the best that we can do is throw a bunch of pills at them.
Yep.
And that's to me, that's disgusting. And there's a lot of places that veterans can go to reach out. And if any veterans are listening right now, you're not going through this alone. Don't feel like you're alone. There's many, many places. The great benefit of having a society that's so connected through social media, you can reach out. I know Boone Cutler's got a great page. There's other veterans pages. But the VA isn't helping you, and they're a government-run entity, so you're probably not going to reach out to your fellow soldiers and your fellow warfighters. And don't be ashamed. I mean, there's local American Legions. There's VFWs. It's not anything to be ashamed of, and it doesn't mean you're less of a man. It means that you've been asked more of a man than anybody else, and it's okay. It's okay to reach out. I mean, you're going to depend on that guy next to you when you're in the heat of battle. Well, you're still in the heat of battle. And a lot of these veterans are not getting the health care that they need to get back in society, and especially if they've lost limbs and everything else. So and talking about mental health, a lot of these guys that are committing these horrific crimes aren't veterans. They're folks, they're kids. These are kids that grew up in a society that, you know, the babysitter was a TV set in a remote control. They grow up in a society that's pounded through the propagandists. A lot of them lean on what their parents, the politics of their parents. And if they're right-wing and conservative and Christian and they buy into that propaganda, you know, that's what you're going to get. On top of the fact that they're probably going through the same thing that every other kid goes through, but they have no outlet. So they take it out in rage. And who knows why this guy did what he did. But up until the point he kicked that door in and pulled the trigger and took the first life, he's a law-abiding citizen. And I don't think you can't write a law that can tell the future. And you can't put regulations and stipulations on gun ownership based on another man's opinion. And now this is where it gets scary for me. And I asked this question online. I said, what if you had a Gulf War vet and an ex-peace officer who went through some hard times and lived within 150 yards of a high school in an elementary school? How would you handle that? How would you handle... I mean, what would be the outcome of that interview? And the guy says, well, obviously he doesn't need a gun because he could be mentally unstable. That was me.
Yeah.
And I can tell you right now, there's not one time in my life, no matter how low and how mad I was at the world, that I ever think for 1 minute to take that pistol and put it to my temple or walk the 100 yards over there and shoot other people. Not once did it cross my mind. It wasn't even a thought.
Because you value life.
Well, yeah, and it's not their fault.
No, that too. But
I mean, if I'm mad at the government because of tickets I got, or if I'm mad at some sort of entity, I can't take it out on innocent people. I mean, I swore an oath twice. I served my country as a peace officer and as a soldier. That alone, I mean, I value other people's rights. And why? What statement would that make? See, I can't wrap my head around guys that go into schools and shoot kids. What is the statement you're trying to make? I don't get it. I don't get what the end result is. I just got a tweet from a listener. A barbecue joint was taken down once or twice. That is true. There have been some massacres of some local barbecue joints. at my hand.
Oh.
Where?
Oh, those ribs.
Is those ribs great or what?
Yeah.
Yeah, I've massacred a few pizzas in my day. Probably more than I should have.
Yeah, it's that comfort eating, man. It's just like...
But you know what? The same way I think, you know, over a third of Americans own firearms. And out of the third of Americans, a very small percentage think it's okay to go take the life of somebody else because of their problems. I mean, it takes a special kind of crazy. But here's the... In any shooting, the shooters are going to go to where they know... In their mind, they are the biggest and baddest things there. Mm-hmm. And that means they're going to go to a gun-free zone, a school, or a cafeteria, or someplace, a business, where there's no guns. A lot of people say in the mind of the shooter, now he becomes the powerful person that he resents.
Yeah. That he could never become
exactly.
Without that gun.
Without that gun. And knowing that he's the only one that has a gun. All the mass shootings that have been stopped by a person with a gun have been stopped early. After that person realizes, hey, I'm not the biggest, baddest guy here, I'm going to go ahead and either take my own life or give up.
Cowards.
Because they are cowards. Absolutely cowards. There was a story that came out that there was an actual veteran that was strapped, and he didn't. First, the story came out that teachers prevented him. Well, no one's going to prevent me, especially some unarmed teacher when I got a gun. And before anybody says, well, you weren't there, you don't know what you would do. I've already been in situations like that. I know exactly what I would do. I would go to the sound of the firing, and I'd assess the situation. He could have done the same thing. I mean, tactically, he could have went over there, kept his gun holstered, went to the sound of the guns, and if the police were there, back off. If the police ain't there yet, go act.
Yeah.
And then when the police show up, put your gun on the ground, put your hands behind your head, and let them sort it out. But stop the threat. Don't let the threat continue. He was like, well, I didn't want to be shot by the police. So you sacrificed the lives of all those people that could not defend themselves because you didn't want to be. And that's another argument. Well, if we have guns in schools, if somebody shot somebody or shot at a gunman, they could miss and injure somebody else while trying to shoot the gunman. Well, but if they shot the gunman and very, you know, nobody was killed or that one person was injured, isn't that better than 30 people getting mowed down just like sheep with no chance whatsoever? I just don't get that mentality.
It's just a victim mentality. It's just like, oh, well... You know, if we just remove it all, then there's a lesser chance rather than having like, well, you know, if we have this option, you know, there's all these hypothetical like what ifs, like, well, what if you hit somebody? It's like, well, I still killed the gunman. So I'm sorry.
Didn't mean to hit him.
But also we people that own guns, I feel like a majority of the people I know owns guns. We living in the state of Texas. We go to gun ranges and we're taught range discipline and things, you know, we're taught, you know, don't just look at what you're shooting, look beyond what you're shooting, mm-hmm. you know, keep, you know, assess the situation, don't panic, breathe, all these things, you know, when we go to the gun ranges, we it becomes an extension of ourselves. It's not like we just like picked up a gun for the first time. We don't know what we're doing. It's in the Second Amendment to be well-regulated.
Yeah.
And by well-regulated means
that's
me.
A well-regulated militia.
Well,
there's nothing in there that says a gun has to be well-regulated.
No, not regulated. No, you didn't let me finish.
Yeah.
Well-regulated and that time disciplined.
Mm-hmm. Well, I'll make the statement. I would say a vast majority of gun owners grew up with guns, were taught gun safety. One of the highlights when I went home for my class reunion is Grandpa took me out skeet shooting, and we blew through like 100 shells and didn't hit much. But, you know, he taught, and there was five of us with shotguns, and nobody got shot. Except, well, even the clay pigeons didn't get shot. But
it doesn't seem like you're well-regulated.
So maybe my regulation was off.
Wind speed. you're used to the Texas humidity, and you're up there in the Michigan humidity. Yeah.
That was it. It was atmospheric. Yeah, that's it. Yeah.
is a polar displacement.
Yeah. And Matt Haisley, host of Straight Talk with Matt Haisley, you can hear every Monday and Friday here at 9 p.m. Central Standard Time, just said they don't show up at PDs or gun shows where they know that he will confront somebody with a gun. And that was kind of funny, too, because they like to throw up at the gun shows, you know, make sure all firearms are unloaded. Well, yeah, you're at a gun show.
Yeah.
But there are people there with loaded handguns.
Yeah. And you don't know who they are or where they're at.
It's not illegal to go into a gun show with a loaded gun. You don't go in there with a loaded gun that you wish to trade.
Mm-hmm.
You clear that. Yeah. And you keep your CHL concealed. I also get a kick out of this. This guy says, I went into this. Of course, you know these stories are all bullshit, but it's good BS. I went into a cafe, and I stood up on the counter, and I said, "Who in here has a gun?" And no one said anything, and we all had a great night. So we were a bunch of unarmed people having lunch, and nobody got hurt. And I'm thinking to myself, if it were me, and I'm strapped, and I'm sitting in there eating lunch, and some idiot stood up and said, "Who in here is carrying a gun?" I'm not going to tell you.
Yeah.
And it's not because I'm a coward. It's none of your damn business.
Right.
That's why it's concealed.
Yeah.
All right. Well, thanks for hanging out, Alex.
No problem.
And discussing this stuff. We're going to talk sports if you want to stick around.
Maybe.
I don't know. Coming up next, Joe Pardini is going to talk about NFL football, college football, and the Chicago Cubs in the bottom of the eighth. They're up over the Pittsburgh Pirates 4-0. Could this be the year? Just a little side note. It's been 107 years since the Cubs won the World Series, and today is my birthday, 10-7. Could it be a sign? I don't know. Stick around. Heather Bumpus in the second hour and Danny Blaze in the third. Stick around. Lots more to come. I'm Mike Allen. This is the Armed Radio Global Network, and you are on the air.
Route 106 Motors is the home of fine pre-owned vehicles. Experience a no-pressure sale with a family-friendly atmosphere. Route 106 Motors has been practicing the same simple philosophy of low prices for over a decade, and it has brought us great success. Recently, while other dealers are closing their doors, Route 106 Motors is expanding. We are a wholesale dealer, and we own the property and pay cash for all the vehicles. This allows us to sell to the consumer for a lot less than the average dealership. We are a high-volume, small-profit dealer, and we pass the savings on to you. New changes have been made at Route 106 Motors. Stop by and check out our brand-new building. Route 106 Motors, located at 569 West Street. Check our website at Route106Motors.com and be sure to like us on Facebook to find out about all the latest deals and savings opportunities. Route106Motors.com.
Are you a gamer? A girl gamer at that? If you're looking for the best hangout point to discuss games, then the right place for you is JoystickGirls.com. Meet new gamers, discuss topics, and share hints and tips. Now looking for new members. So sign up today at the new site that keeps getting better and better, JoystickGirls.com.
Are you ready to take your webpage to the next level? Go to IceGram.com and download for free all the tools you will need to enhance your webpage content for potential customers, clients, or fans. Capture leads, call your audience to action, skyrocket conversation and engagement with action bars, pop-ups, toast notifications, message boxes, overlays, and sidebars. Head on over to IceGram.com for your free download. That's IceGram.com. Bottom line, you'll love it.
Hey there, all you creepy people. This is Kevin Wayne from Portland, Oregon. You're listening to Armed Radio, home of the big guns.
Hey, everybody, this is Jimmy.
And this is Paul.
We are hosting a new show called Pod Talk.
politically offensive talk.
It's going to be about politics, religion, the presidential race, current events.
We're going to have some guests that come on, hopefully Donald Trump himself. Wishful thinking.
No, we're going to have Hillary on.
Yeah, but that would be nice. I'd love to get a hold of Hillary.
I throw any fucking that.
So come and join us on Thursday nights at 11 p.m. Eastern, right after Night Talk with Joe Rocks.
Christ almighty, it's like I'm sitting here playing cards with my brother's kids or something. You nerve-wracking sons of bitches.
Armed Radio Global presents its new 2015 Talk at Night lineup.
Mondays, 8 p.m. Eastern, spot on with Lino and Tom.
Straight Talk with Matt Haisley. Mondays and Fridays, 10 p.m. Eastern.
On Tuesdays, Talk Time with Val, 8 p.m. Eastern, followed by High Five at 10 p.m. Eastern with Johnny and Mikey.
Wednesdays on the air with Mike Allen, 10 p.m. EST. And Thursdays, Night Talk with Joe Rocks, 10 p.m. Eastern.
Join the talk now on Ustream TV. Replays on Spreaker, exclusively on Armed Radio Global.
All right, welcome back to the show. We're going to move on now. We're going to talk about sports. Cubbies are up 4-0, top of the ninth. And this is awesome. The Cubs are going to probably roll the Pirates and move on. Tonight's broadcast is brought to you by thehotsaucevault.com. Go to thehotsaucevault.com. Check out all the variations of hot sauce that they have there. It is amazing. It is awesome. Order some, they'll deliver it right to your door. If you like hot sauce, like I like hot sauce, hotsaucevault.com is the place to go. Proud sponsors of Armed Radio Global. Please welcome on the Ring Central Celebrity Hotline, our muse, the man about town. He is the sporting guru that'll tell you who to spend all your money on if betting was if it was legal. Please welcome back to the show our prognosticator supreme, Mr. Joe Pardini. How are you doing, sir?
Pretty good, my friend. How are you two tonight?
Man, I'm still hurting. I'm still hurting for Monday night, dude. I broke my TV. Freaking Lions got robbed again. Just nothing's going right for my team, dude.
Hey, I was at Penn State this weekend.
You went to the game? Yeah, the Penn State Army game. How was that?
Oh well, it started raining Friday night, and it didn't stop raining until 2 p.m. So I was in the rain all day long on Saturday. So when it's raining, you always don't want to be in the rain, right?
Except if it's a football game.
Well, I was right in the front row. It soaked for about almost 3 hours.
Yeah, but you're in the front row, man. How cool is that?
Yeah, it was. It was great. My ass was wet for about almost 3 hours. I was on the 20-yard line, and Penn State almost blew the game.
Against Army?
Yes. They only won 20-14.
Wow. Well, Penn's probably, we talked about this at the beginning of the year. Penn State's probably only going to be a little over 500 team. They'll make a bowl, but they're not going to be anything in the Big Ten.
Well,
Ohio State's
going to be. You have Michigan and Detroit, and I have the Eagles at Penn State.
Yeah, and right now the Eagles are doing better than the Lions.
I don't think so. We only got one win.
We got no wins. What are you talking? You don't think so? We got nothing.
Hey,
0-4.
I don't see us winning again. I don't know. It's hard.
I don't know. I think you will. I think you guys are going to be in the top of the East. The East isn't all that good. So, you know, you got. you got Dallas. You got half their team hurt, so you know they're not going to do anything. And then you got the only one I'd be worried about is I would worry about the Redskins.
The Redskins, you say?
Because they got Cousins. Well, they're 2-2, and they got Cousins playing good. I mean, once they got rid of their baggage, and I don't think RG3 is going to be around much longer. I think they're gonna try to get something for him. But Kirk Cousins is making it happen. They're 2-2, and right now it's them and Dallas on the top of the East. But Dallas got those three quick wins, but they're not going to win again for a while.
They're not going to win again.
No, I mean, well, this weekend they're not going to win. They're playing the Patriots. They're going to get killed.
Yeah, the Patriots are giving nine.
I give it more than that. I mean, it's going to be another 50-point ball game. Dude, the Patriots are pissed off. You got a bunch of talented Super Bowl champions who are angry. They're hanging 40, 50 points on people, and their defense is just killing it. And that week off might have hurt them a little bit, but they're playing a Detroit Cowboys team that is just it's ravaged by injuries. I mean, there's nobody left. You got your number one receivers out for another couple of weeks. You got your quarterback out. You got your defensive lineman out. You got a linebacker and a cornerback out. Yeah, I mean, it's a little walking mash unit. And everybody's healthy in New England. So I'll give you 20. I'll give you 30 on that one. And right now the Patriots aren't playing for. You know, okay, we're gonna get up by 20, 30 points and then lay off. They're pushing it all the way to the end because they're mad. They're angry. Those are angry.
So you're saying 50 points, huh?
My final score for the Cowboys, I put 45-0.
He's saying 45-0. So I got some update news here.
What you got?
We got a minute left in the hockey game. The Rangers are up 3-2, and they just caused a fight. And the Pirates are in the bottom of the ninth.
Who are they playing? The Rangers.
Who? They're playing the Blackhawks. Chicago.
Ah, okay. Is the Red Wings playing tonight? It's the only team I can follow in hockey.
I'm a Flyer fan, but I think all my teams in Philly suck. But I don't know. I could see them on the list tonight, so... let's see. No.
They play tomorrow?
The next game is probably tomorrow because they only show day by day.
Ah, okay.
So the next game is the LA Kings against the Sharks. It's on NBC Sports.
Okay. Well, no one really cares about hockey right now because it's the beginning of that season, and I don't really get interested in hockey until like next spring. Because hockey's like the NBA. I could care less about the NBA until you get into the playoffs. And it's like baseball. I could care less about baseball all through the summer. I might watch a game here and there if the Tigers are playing or if the Cubbies are playing, I'll watch them. But, you know, after that, until it gets into October, I don't really care. Because they play 168 games. That's a lot of freaking games. So I don't really care about hockey. We're not going to talk about hockey. Hockey's later. We'll talk about hockey next year. Right now, it's football season.
No, wait a minute. Now, you know why the ratings are bad for sports?
For what?
Sports in general. You know why the ratings are bad for sports in general?
Parody.
They overlap each other. But baseball should be over by now. You know what I mean?
Well here's the thing. Football. Here's the thing. Right now, it's the beginning of the football season. It's the end of the baseball season. It really doesn't matter if it overlaps at this point because there's really not anything happening. Anything can happen. You got 16 games in a football season. By the time you get halfway through the season, that's when you start seeing your playoff teams and stuff. That's when you start seeing them vet out. And now you can start getting interested in that. But hockey at this point, I mean, if the Rangers win tonight, they're 1-0. Who gives a crap? It's a playoff season. We got a one-game playoff between the Cubs and the Pirates, bottom of the ninth. The Cubbies now have two outs, and they're one out away from going to play the who do they play next?
I think they're going to play St. Louis.
So they're going to go play St. Louis.
Yes. And Dodgers will play the Mets. And Texas is going to play Toronto. And Houston's playing Kansas City.
Well, I'm watching Houston and the Cubs.
Well, I think...
So no hockey, okay? Toronto? Joe, we're not talking any hockey until at least March, okay?
All right, so right now, I think Toronto's going to beat Texas. It's going to go 5 games.
Yeah, I can see that.
I see... I can even see Kansas City and Houston going 5.
Yeah, I can see that. Cubs are probably going to get it in 3.
Well, you're saying my prediction is St. Louis is going to win the World Series.
Nah, it's the Cubs year, man. It's the Cubs year.
He's saying it's the Cubs year, I'm going to go with my. I'm going to go with my prediction, St. Louis, and 4 games, and then I have to go with.
Well, who are they playing? Who's St. Louis going to play?
Mets.
The Mets?
Over the Dodgers.
Mets or the Dodgers. So St. Louis against the Mets and the Dodgers, and they'll take the World Series in 4. That's your prediction.
Oh, they're going to play Toronto in the World Series.
That's why I just asked you.
They're going to go 7 games in the World Series.
So St. Louis versus Toronto, and St. Louis will take it in 4. Is that what you're saying?
In 7.
Oh, it's going to go the full 7 now. All right.
Yeah.
Trying to follow you here, buddy.
All right. The game is over.
Cubs are going. Yep. Cubs are going. That's awesome.
So that's pretty good. So that'll be – just remember now, when's the last time the Cubs had a playoff game in Chicago?
The last time the Cubs went to the World Series was 107 years ago.
No, I mean, when's the last time they had a playoff game in Chicago?
Oh, it's like in the 20s. I mean, it was a long time ago.
No.
That's the bobble.
The bar race?
No, that's when the guy reached out and grabbed the foul ball and then kept the last out.
Yeah, but they played who did they play when that Steve, what's it called? They just showed his picture on Facebook, too.
Yeah, that was actually the game that they had to win to go to the World Series. So they made it to the semis. They made it to the pennant, and they lost. I can't remember who it was.
Wasn't that against Colorado?
I don't even care. I don't even know.
Because I remember the last time when the Cubs had a game, that was back in 84, 85, when they played the Pot Race when Tony Gwynn was on the team.
Yeah, but they haven't made it to the World Series since like 1902.
Holy shoot.
Yeah, they haven't, and they haven't won it since then either. it's been a long dry spell.
Maybe they will win this year, but
that's what I'm pulling for. I got to pull for the Cubbies.
I have money on the Cardinals.
My Tigers are out of it. I got to pull for the Cubs. I'm just pulling for the Cubs in Houston. That's what I'd like to see get all the way through. But all right. Well, we just spent wasted the first segment talking about hockey. So we're not going to talk about hockey anymore. So go ahead and mute up. We're going to come back at the top of the hour. We're going to get back to what's important, and that is football, my friend. Football. We'll have your picks for the NFL and college right after this. We're talking to Joe Pardini. He is the prognosticator supreme for On the Air with Mike Allen. We'll be back after these messages. I'm Mike Allen. This is the Armed Radio Global Network. You're on the air.
Yeah. Is your wife wicked hot? Or is she just cold?
Do you just want to take a hot shower?
Call Savino Mechanical for all your heating, hot water, and cooling needs. Savino Mechanical has been servicing Greater Boston and Southern New Hampshire for over a quarter century.
Quality 24-hour service.
Reasonable rates. Satisfaction guaranteed.
Licensed and insured.
And remember, at Savino Mechanical, we are not comfortable until you are. Call Savino Mechanical today
at 1-855-624-4280.
That's 1-855-624-4280. Savino Mechanical.
Hey, everybody, this is Jimmy.
And this is Paul.
We are hosting a new show called Pod Talk, Politically Offensive Talk.
It's going to be about politics, religion, the presidential race, current events.
We're going to have some guests that come on, hopefully Donald Trump himself. Wishful thinking.
No, we're going to have Hillary on.
Yeah, but that would be nice. I'd love to get a hold of Hillary.
I throw any fucking that.
So come and join us on Thursday nights at 11 p.m. Eastern, right after Night Talk with Joe Rocks.
Tune in every Monday and Friday night, 10 p.m. Eastern Time, for Straight Talk with Matt Haisley. Live audio on TuneIn Radio and Spreaker.com. Plus, live video on Ustream.tv. From the demented minds at ArmedRadioGlobal.com.
Crown Military Miniatures celebrates this holiday season with an enormous selection of new and vintage collector quality toy soldiers. You have to see the photorealistic detail on the World War II armor or the sheer volume of the figures from the American Civil War to the Zulu Wars to the Jacobite Rebellion. If soldiers were there, Crown Military Miniatures has it covered in little men cast in pewter. Veterans, active duty personnel, and military enthusiasts, you have to check out Crown Military Miniatures. Visit them online at crowntoysoldiers.com or visit their store at 88 North Broadway in tax-free Salem, New Hampshire.
Hey, Joe Rocks, it's Louis Avis straight from Chi-Town. Call and talk about our website, www.hotsaucevault.com. We got everything you can think of out there, Joe. The hottest hot sauce is not for wimps, mild, medium sauces. We got barbecue sauces, snacks, some of our gift ideas and gag gifts, so you can go out and check us out at www.hotsaucevault.com. Hope to talk to you again on your radio show. Kick-ass show. Had a great time last week. Hope to hear from you soon. Take care, Joe. Hotsaucevault.com.
Hi, now I know you hear Joe Rocks on their weekly restaurant reviews on Night Talk, 10 p.m. Eastern. And boy, these two like to eat. Right, boys? Well, here's something to review right from your house. Eat24. That's right, eat24.com. With over 25,000 restaurants for you to choose from when you're hungry. Many in your area. So review that, boys. Eat24.com. Click, order, and eat. Eat24.com.
Tune in every Monday and Friday night, 10 p.m. Eastern Time, for Straight Talk with Matt Haisley. Live audio on TuneIn Radio and Spreaker.com. Plus, live video on Ustream.tv. From the demented minds at ArmedRadioGlobal.com.
Now, back to some ass-kicking shiznat
from Nullsoft Shoutcast.
Welcome back to the show. Tonight's broadcast brought to you by E24.com. Put that app on your phone, folks. Put it in your phone. Put in a zip code of where you're at. They will find you a restaurant which will deliver food to you. It's like having a food truck in your pants. Of course, hotsaucevault.com. I've been there, folks. It's like hot sauce heaven. It's awesome. Go to hotsaucevault.com. Pick your brand of hot sauce. They've got hundreds to choose from. Proud sponsors of Armed Radio Global. Back on the Ring Central Celebrity Hotline, the prognosticator supreme, the man with the plan. If I can get him to stop talking about that silly sport of hockey that's got like a 12-month season and a two-week off season, and it doesn't even matter right now because they just started their first game tonight out of 106,000 games that they're going to play. All right, let's talk football, Joe.
Hey, my friend.
And that caller that was trying to...
We won't even talk about hockey. That's not the key word today.
No, we're not talking about hockey till after Christmas.
After Christmas, now New Year's.
Even after New Year's. No, we're not talking to hockey. We're not talking about hockey till after March. When they get into their playoffs, when we get into playoffs, we'll talk hockey. Okay.
All right, you ready?
All right, so let's get some break down some football. Let's go college first. What are the two games that you're picking for me this week? What are we breaking down here?
Oklahoma gave it 17 to Texas.
17 points, that's it?
Yeah, Oklahoma's giving 17. You know why?
Why?
They're playing at that fairground.
Yeah, that doesn't matter.
So you're thinking, I think Texas got to play close, or the coach is fired.
Well, they're not going to play close. They're going to get beat down.
Is that a national TV game?
Hey, hold on a minute. Joe, hey, the caller that was trying to call during the commercials, go ahead and give me a call now. Give me a call back. That's why I wasn't answering, because we're in the middle of commercials. So go ahead and give me a call back now if you want to call in. I saw the number up there. So give us a call back. Go ahead, Joe.
So, like I said, is that on national TV?
Well, of course it's on national TV. It's always on national TV. It doesn't matter. Look, let me tell you something. Charlie Strong took over from Mack Brown. Mack Brown had a tremendous 12-year run. He really did put Texas back into one of the premier football programs. I get that. But during that time, he lost control of his players. So his players weren't living on campus. They were living in their own apartments. They were taken, they were pampered. They were basically, Mack Brown's last year there, you had a bunch of entitled brats that played for Texas. And I'm gonna be honest with you. Because they got comfortable. They got comfortable because they just knew they were going to win. And when they started getting beat and when Mack left, when Charlie came in, that's the mess he walked into, is all these kids that got comfortable. And so he pulled them back into campus. They have to live in the dorms. They had to go to class, which was like a big that was awkward for a lot of the older classmen that had been there for a couple of years because they're not used to that. You know, they felt entitled. And so Charlie got rid of a lot of them. And then they started getting in trouble, and he got rid of them. I mean, he had coaches, the football players had to wear a uniform to class, not a football uniform, but they had to wear, to identify themselves as players. And then Charlie tasked his coaches to go and make sure that all the players were in the classes they were supposed to be in and sitting in the front row. That was never – the players didn't even show up to class before then. Now they got to show up to class. So he's
they don't get to play football then.
Well, yeah. And so what happened was, a lot of these players – a lot of these players, when they started having to do all this stuff, left. Now, we got a caller that's just calling in. Welcome to the show. Caller, where are you calling from? And you're on the air.
Thank you. I'm calling in from North Austin, Texas. How are you?
How are you doing, sir? And your name, sir?
Chuck.
Chuck Licata. Is this Chuck Licata?
Yes. Yes, it is, Mr. Mike Allen.
And Chuck Licata of K-Mac Sports. Welcome to the show. I'm so honored to have you on. Chuck runs K-Mac Sports, responsible for broadcasting a lot of the high school sports around the area. And I guess this Friday I'll be filling in for the Manor Elgin game, and I'm happy to do it. I'm really excited. Welcome to the show, Chuck.
Yes, I was wondering does your audience know how multi-talented you are?
I don't know.
Well, am I allowed to say some of the things that I know about you as far as what you've announced? I think your audience should be well aware of the fact that you've done, you know, you been public address announcing at various events.
Yep.
And you've done, obviously, broadcasting. Besides hosting a show, you've done play-by-play, you've done color. And, you know, we are thrilled to have Mike Allen call play-by-play for the Elgin Wildcats this coming Friday. We're thrilled.
Oh, man,
I'm looking forward to listening to the replay.
Well, thank you very much. Thank you.
Although, what you have to understand, though, okay, there's a little bit of expectation, though. Now, see, as you all know by now, Elgin was winless going into last week's game, okay? They opened up district play at Waco. Now, they signed with KMAC Sports during the week, last week, okay? And lo and behold, they're now KMAC Quiet. What do? They go out and they win their first game of the season. So, on KMAC Sports, the Wildcats are now 1-0.
1-0. So, well, they got a tough opponent Friday. Maynard's no slouch.
Yeah, Maynard's probably, I'm not sure how to assess Elgin at this point. Maynard is definitely one of the better teams, one of the top three teams in the district. But from what I've heard, they're beatable. So, you know, and again, Elgin's 1-0 in KMAC. We don't want to mess that up or screw that up.
Well, I'll do my very best. Well, right now we're talking. No pressure at all. I can handle that. Well, I got Barry Cox is going to be up there doing color and helping me out with engineering, and we met earlier this week, and we're on the same sheet of music. I think we're going to have a good broadcast. But now we're talking about Texas and Oklahoma this weekend, the big Red River rivalry. Joe Pardini is from Philadelphia. He's my on-air prognosticator. He's thinking now, Joe. How many points has Texas given? 12.
No, 17. Oklahoma's given 17.
17 points. So it's Oklahoma minus 17. I think it's going to be Oklahoma minus 50. I hate to say
I did hear you talk about Mac in the last years of his coaching was absolutely right on. I wish Mac Brown followers could hear that and understand that it really was that bad. Okay? Now, that said... And so, by the way, I'm an Erie, Pennsylvania native, so I'm loving Philly. I'm loving the Philly connection. I'm going in with Joe. I'm going in with my Philly brother, and I'm saying Texas is going to keep it closer than 17.
Well, I know he has to keep it closer. I think what he's going through right now, just from looking at it from a perspective, I'm not a Texas fan. I don't hate Texas. I mean, I'll root for them because I have to watch them. I mean, it's local. I'm a Michigan fan, to be quite honest with you, and I'm just ecstatic what's going on up there. But I think Charlie has to – he still has that element of older upperclassmen that he did not recruit that is kind of resentful. I mean, they went to Texas to have the good life, and the good life was stripped away from them, and now they're expected to perform and get good grades, and they're kind of rebelling. I mean, they had that one cat – that was tweeting. He's an upperclassman. He was tweeting during halftime, hey, I'm looking to transfer. And Charlie's the type of guy who's going to give him that transfer. And he's got, what, seven true freshmen playing? And then playing for him, starting for him right now? I mean, if they let him hang around, Texas is going to be scary in the next 2-3 years. But not this year. They're not. Because there's just too much dissension. The upperclassmen don't get along with the freshmen, I mean, there's just too much. This is the growing pain. This is the valley that you have to go through to harden yourself to become the championship team that they're going to become. Now, Mac Brown stepped into an awesome situation where Makovic did an excellent job recruiting. He walked into a Heisman Trophy winner. He walked into a great offensive setup. Vince Young was on his way, and that was all. Those are all people forget that Makovic didn't leave a train wreck. He left Mac a pretty good setup, so he walked in a good setup, and then he just built on it. Charlie's got to start from scratch.
Yeah, it's really tough. I mean, you know, and unfortunately, as you guys both talked about, you know, Texas fans are.
you know, they're kind of like Mac Brown's players in the last couple of years. They're entitled. They won't put up with, you know, 50-point debacles at TCU, no matter how much better TCU is than Texas.
Yeah.
And it's a shame because they're, you know, pick a college program, Alabama. You know, they had their down years. They were getting their butts kicked once upon a time. So
yeah, and so was Oklahoma.
Texas fans just don't put up with that.
Yeah, Oklahoma was down. Nebraska's down now. Ever since they went to the Big Ten and left the Big 12, I think the only teams that really left the Big 12 that are doing really well is A&M, and they're a top team in the SEC. A lot of people thought they were going to be a bottom dweller.
Yeah, them and Missouri did very well for itself.
Yeah, and Missouri's got a good program.
I was really impressed with what Missouri did.
Yeah, so. Well, we got Chuck Licata of KMAC Sports, Joe Pardini on the Ring Central Celebrity Hotline. Now, Joe.
Big Joe.
Big Joe Pardini. I tell you, Joe is probably, as far as prognostication and breaking down teams, and he has been right a lot. I mean, I can't bet because I bet with emotion. I have no way to break it down. And Joe kind of does too. But now, Joe, you say 17 points. You think it's going to be under 17, Joe?
Yeah, I think it's going to be a close game because the players got to play their hearts out. You know, I mean, you can't get whipped again two straight weeks in a row.
Well, you can.
You know, I mean, if you do it, you're good. You got to think these kids are playing to get into the next level.
Yeah.
So if you're going to get whipped again, it's like.
And a lot of these kids were playing high school ball last year. So now this is a big stage. Even though Texas is down, playing in front of 100,000 people is pretty dang intimidating.
Yeah, and it's
well,
kind of
a
fairground.
I got. I'll go ahead. What's the over and under on this?
It's 61.
I'll go over. Nah, I won't. I'll go under. But I think I think Oklahoma's going to pitch a shutout, and I got it at 45-0. 45-0.
Oh my God!
What do you got, Chuck?
Dude, what have you been smoking? That's what I want to know.
Hey, that's my call. That's it. I'm not always right, but there it is.
I'm gonna say, either Oklahoma keeps it or Texas keeps it close, and Oklahoma pulls away steadily over the second half, or Oklahoma goes up like, say, 34-14 or something, and then UT rallies, Gerard gets things going. And then, you know, let's face it, when you play and you're so far behind, that's when you start scoring points. I think Texas makes it 34-24. I can see Texas scoring 24 points on OU.
So 34-24, so you're going over the 61.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. At the over?
Okay. No, that's 58. That's 58.
Oh, okay, 58.
34-24. Yeah, so I'm still under. I'm with you. I'm the under.
So you're taking definitely the under, but you're taking a close game. Within 10.
Yep.
Within 10. So,
within 10, yep.
So you'll take Texas plus, you'll take the 17. Texas plus 17,
yeah,
in the under. Okay.
I'm with Jeff. I'm with my Philly brother. I'm taking the
see, 17. I knew. As soon as you said Philly brother, I was out of line. I'm outnumbered now. I knew it. And
it's your show. That sucks.
And,
huh?
and Joe is trying to get me in a Philly jersey, and that's never going to happen, ever.
Well, wow. Tell him the bet we made.
Well, I'm not putting on a Philly jersey.
Well,
you talking about Philadelphia Flyers?
Eagles.
Oh, okay.
Here's the bet. I told him if the Eagles lost and Penn State lost, I would have to put on a Detroit jersey with a Michigan hat.
Yeah.
Okay.
And then if Penn State won and the Eagles win, he would have to wear a Penn State hat with an Eagles jersey.
Yeah, that's not going to happen.
That's only fair.
Well, the only thing that
saves
the only thing that saves me is that Penn State's down and the Eagles are at best a train wreck. And I think Michigan's going to win out.
Michigan is salty, man. I love them.
I think they're going to win out.
They're fun.
Yeah,
they're fun.
I think after pitching two shutouts, the coach has got them mentally where they need to be. And their next big tough game is going to be Ohio State, and I am taking the day off.
Oh, yeah.
I am getting beer.
That's gonna be huge.
And I'm getting a bunch of meat to put on the grill. And you are welcome, Chuck, if you'd like to come over for that.
Oh, definitely.
And we will drink copious amounts of alcohol and watch my Michigan Wolverines hopefully beat the Ohio State Buckeyes. Well, I got to take a break. What we got to do here is we're all on the same channel. So mute your phones once I get the commercials done. And then, Chuck, can you stick around?
Absolutely. I'd love to, man. Thank you.
And, Joe, you're still awake?
Yes, I'm still awake, Mike.
You fell asleep on me last week, Chuck.
Hey, I still have to put my ticket before we leave this commercial break.
Well, hold on. Come back with your pick. Texas. Yeah, go ahead.
I got Oklahoma 41, Texas 28.
So you got the under. No, you're over. You got the over.
No, it's 61.
Yeah.
It's, I'm over.
Yeah, so you got the over. And
they're winning by 13.
So you'll take, so are you picking Oklahoma minus 17?
No, I'm taking the
Texas plus 17. Texas plus 17 and the over.
Yeah, and they'll lose by 13, but they'll cover.
Ah, okay. I see what you're saying. Okay. Got it. Okay.
Gotcha.
All right, we'll be right back. You guys meet up. I got to pay the bills here. All right, we got Chuck Licata, KMAC Sports, and Joe Pardini, the On the Air with Mike Allen, Prognosticator Supreme, two Philly boys, smelling up the man cave like cheesesteak. I'm Mike Allen. This is the Armed Radio Global Network. And we'll be back after these messages.
Night Talk with Joe Rocks. 10 p.m. Eastern. Thursdays is now on Ustream TV. Spreaker for replays and live. On Live 365 exclusively on Armed Radio Global.
Route 106 Motors is the home of fine pre-owned vehicles. Experience a no-pressure sale with a family-friendly atmosphere. Route 106 Motors has been practicing the same simple philosophy of low prices for over a decade, and it has brought us great success. Recently, while other dealers are closing their doors, Route 106 Motors is expanding. We are a wholesale dealer, and we own the property and pay cash for all the vehicles. This allows us to sell to the consumer for a lot less than the average dealership. We are a high-volume, small-profit dealer, and we pass the savings on to you. New changes have been made at Route 106 Motors. Stop by and check out our brand-new building. Route 106 Motors, located at 569 West Street. Check our website at Route106Motors.com and be sure to like us on Facebook to find out about all the latest deals and savings opportunities. Route106Motors.com.
Are you a gamer? A girl gamer at that? If you're looking for the best hangout point to discuss games, then the right place for you is JoystickGirls.com. Meet new gamers, discuss topics, and share hints and tips. Now looking for new members. So sign up today at the new site that keeps getting better and better, joystickgirls.com.
Hey, Joe Rocks, it's Louis Avis straight from Chi-Town. Come and talk about our website, www.hotsaucevault.com. We got everything you can think of out there, Joe. The hottest hot sauce is not for wimps, mild, medium sauces. We got barbecue sauces, snacks, some of our gift ideas and gag gifts, so you can go out and check us out at www.hotsaucevault.com. Hope to talk to you again on your radio show. Kick-ass show. Had a great time last week. Hope to hear from you soon. Take care, Joe. HotSauceVault.com.
Are you ready to take your webpage to the next level? Go to icegram.com and download for free all the tools you will need to enhance your webpage content for potential customers, clients, or fans. Capture leads, call your audience to action, skyrocket conversation and engagement with action bars, pop-ups, toast notifications, message boxes, overlays, and sidebars. Head on over to icegram.com for your free download. That's icegram.com. Bottom line, you'll love it.
Hey there, all you creepy people. This is Kevin Wayne from Portland, Oregon. You're listening to Armed Radio, home of the big guns.
Armed Radio Global presents its new 2015 Talk at Night lineup.
Mondays, 8 p.m. Eastern. Spot on with Lino and Tom.
Straight Talk with Matt Haisley. Mondays and Fridays, 10 p.m. Eastern.
On Tuesdays, Talk Time with Val, 8 p.m. Eastern, followed by High Five at 10 p.m. Eastern with Johnny and Mikey.
Wednesdays on the air with Mike Allen, 10 p.m. EST. And Thursdays, Night Talk with Joe Rocks, 10 p.m. Eastern.
Join the talk now on Ustream TV. Replays on Spring. Exclusively on Armed Radio Global.
Christ almighty, it's like I'm sitting here playing cards with my brother's kids or something. You nerve-wracking sons of bitches.
All right, welcome back to the show. Tonight's broadcast brought to you by Eat24.com. Put the phone app from either iTunes or Google Play on your phone. Put in the zip code of where you are at. They will find a restaurant near you that will deliver food to you. Let's say you're out of town on a business trip, sitting in that conference room listening to those boring presentations, and everybody's thinking about lunch, and you got 30 minutes to get out and get back, and everybody's trying to find out where to go to get lunch, wait in line, buy their food, scarf it down, and come back. You don't have to do that. All you have to do is put in the zip code of where you're at, find a restaurant that'll deliver, and as everybody's rushing out to lunch, your lunch is rushing in. It's like having a food truck in your pants. Eat24.com, proud sponsor of Armed Radio Global, along with HotSauceVault.com. If you like hot sauce like I like hot sauce, HotSauceVault.com is a place to go. They've got a wide variety of all sorts of different levels of hotness for their hot sauce. Order it. Comes right to your door. Can't get any easier than that. HotSauceVault.com. Welcome back to the Central Texas Man Cave of Armed Radio Global. And joining me live on the Ring Central Celebrity Hotline from KMAC Sports, Chuck Licata, and our own Joe Pardini, the On the Air with Mike Allen football and sports prognosticator. Welcome back, guys.
Hey, man.
All right, so Joe, you've picked some other games for us. What's the other college game that we got here going on?
All right. Now, there's no line. There's no line on the over and under on the points of the Penn State-Indiana game. But there is a spread on it. Penn State is given 8 to Indiana, and it's homecoming.
You know, Indiana almost beat Ohio State. You know that, right?
Yes. So, you're up, Mike. This is your show.
Okay.
This is the pressure cooker.
So, it's Indiana minus 8?
Yeah. Indiana's getting 8.
I'll take Indiana minus the 8. And what's the no over and under on this?
Nope.
Can we make one up?
Well, ask Chuck. Chuck is the special guest. You want to make it up?
No, I'll be honest with you. I don't know Indiana well enough to say. So I'm going to let you guys.
Well, let's put the over and under at 35.
You're going to say 35.
And I got the over.
He's taking the over. See, that's why he went in at 35.
I think Indiana.
You know, most college teams have 35 by halftime.
I think Indiana's going to.
That's what I was thinking. I mean, seriously.
Indiana's going to have that game put away pretty.
Right?
I mean, you struggle against.
Let Chuck go next.
You're playing Indiana, who almost beat Ohio State, and mm-hmm. Penn State, who almost lost to Army.
Yeah.
At home. So.
Well, you got to think though. It was raining in Happy Valley, and I was at the game.
What does that mean? It's raining. So what? It's raining. So who cares? That's football weather, yeah, man.
Well, go ahead, Chuck. You go first, and then I'll explain the theory on this.
Okay.
Actually, what I want to do, if it's okay with the show host, I'd like to ask my Philly brother a quick set of three questions. Number one, is Mike Schmidt's cheesesteak still some of the best in Philly? Number two, do you remember the Broad Street Bully days, the Bobby Clark, the Bernie Perrant days? And number three, how bad is Chip Kelly getting it from Philly fans right now?
Well, no, the Broad Street Bully, I was the only 5 years old. I'm 71. I was born in 71.
Okay.
And what was the first one?
All right, so I'm 10 years older than you are, so I remember them very well.
So, okay, so and next question. Chip Kelly?
You know, I think Chip Kelly is on the right track. Believe it or not, I'm not a Philly fan. Let's put it this way. I'm a Philly fan when they play the Cowboys. But Chip Kelly is another one of these coaches that you got to give him a little bit of time. Because he's trying to create a culture there that hasn't existed in Philadelphia since the 70s.
I disagree with you there, Mike.
You think
you're
so?
You're going to tell me that Andy Reid didn't build that team?
I think Andy Reid did as much as he could with what the ownership allowed him to do. I think they have the same kind of problems that Detroit and Dallas have with ownership. I tell you right now, the problem with the Detroit Lions is the owners don't care if they win or not. I'm saying it live. And if you're listening up in Detroit, I'll own it. Fords don't give a crap. They're making money. They're making money off of ticket sales. They're making money off. They got rabid fans up there in Detroit, and they're like Philly. Philly has rabid fans. There are fans that will fight you. I mean, they have a jail at their damn stadium, okay? So, I mean, these are fans that deserve a Super Bowl. But why don't they have a Super Bowl? They make the same amount of money. They have the same amount of access to talent. Why don't they win? Well, their owners don't give a crap. And if any of those owners want to call in my show and debate me on that, call me. Tell me why you haven't won anything since the 50s and 60s.
I'll be on that show.
Yeah. I'd love to have Clay Ford, not Clay, with the Ford family from Detroit. Tell me. Tell me why you don't want to win a Super Bowl. And don't tell me you want to, because if you wanted to, you'd have done it. Don't tell me.
Same thing with the Eagles. Same thing with the Eagles.
And Cleveland's just sad. I don't know what's going on in Cleveland. They need to start Johnny Manziel in Cleveland. What they need to do, stop messing around.
God.
So who did you
Cleveland is sadly becoming the former LA Clippers of the NFL.
Well, the Cleveland and the Cubs. Right. You know, there's only four teams that have never been to a Super Bowl ever. Two of them are the two original teams in the NFL, Detroit and Cleveland. The other two is Jacksonville and Houston. Two new teams. They're not even 20 years old. And then you got the Detroit and Cleveland, which are going on 80 years old. They haven't won a championship since the 50s. Tell me that's not... Wow. I mean, they haven't even been to a Super Bowl. Mm. How can you not go to a Super Bowl? I mean, I broke my – if you kept up with me on Facebook, I got so mad I threw my baseball hat at a plasma TV. Okay, never do that. And it hit just right. It hit just right. So it cost me a plasma TV. I was so mad. I was like, why can't we win these games? What the hell? Anyway, we're getting off track.
All right, Chuck. So pick the Penn State score.
Pick the Penn State score?
Yes.
I'm going to go. I've got to go Nittany Lions. I'm sorry. You just got to. You know, I'm going to go 28. I'm going to go 24-21. I don't think they even score 28. They got 24-21.
24-21 Nittany Lions over Indiana?
Yep.
I got 40. Yep. I got 42-0 Indiana.
Oh, my God.
I'm going. Hey, Mike, we can make this interesting now. You want to make this interesting?
I'm not wearing an Eagles jersey, Joe. I'm not doing it.
Right? Hey, Chuck, what's the gig? You're going to be on next week, right, Chuck?
My skin will literally burn off my body if I put on an Eagles jersey.
You'll be on, right, next week?
Yeah. Absolutely.
Yeah, Chuck. Well, yeah, you're welcome. Absolutely. Yeah, you're welcome on any time, Chuck.
Although you better win the Elgin game Friday. Oh, sorry. Never mind.
I might be banned.
What should we do to Mike if Penn State wins? What should Mike do for us?
They got an outright win, not cover the points. They got an outright win.
Well, they got an outright win.
You said Indiana was going to blow them out of the joint.
I think they are.
So, I'm taking Penn State 30-17.
Oof. Wow. Very nice.
Because you got to figure it out. Francis is on the hot seat with the fans.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
That's true.
And the quarterback has not been perfect. He was supposed to be the number one draft pick or first round pick, and he hasn't impressed me yet. And if Penn State gets their best running backs back, that freshman running back who's been tearing it up, I don't think Indiana's going to stop them.
I think they are. They almost beat Ohio State.
Don't forget, in Happy Valley, so, you know.
They almost beat Ohio State in the shoe.
Yeah, Happy Valley and homecoming.
Yeah, but they almost beat Ohio State in Columbus.
Yes. So,
Michigan's going to expose Ohio State.
God, I hope so.
Sorry.
I hope so. That's going to be a great day. Game. All right, what's the next game? Mike. What's the next game?
This one's for Mike. Mike loves Mike. It's Michigan giving 8 to Northwestern.
I'll take that. What's the over and under?
35.
I'll take the over.
Oh, I got the over. Michigan's going to score at least 35 themselves.
Yeah, they're going to destroy them. They got confidence.
They're going to
They're cocky.
Yeah.
They're good. I mean, Coach Harbaugh, how cool is that? When I found out when it was final that Jim was coming home, I was like, praise the Lord. This is awesome. We're done with all these experimental coaches that are trying to change the culture at Michigan. Michigan football is we're going to hand the ball to a big guy, and he's going to run behind other big guys, and those big guys are going to cram it down your throat. And after we cram it down your throat and wear you down, then we're going to back up in the pocket and just tear you apart. That's Michigan football. Punch you in the face.
Score, Mike.
Jeez. 42 I don't think they're going to pitch a shutout again because Northwestern does have a halfway decent offense. So 42-10.
What's Northwestern's record?
I'm not even sure. I think they're 2-2, maybe? 3-2?
I don't know. I'm not close to a computer.
Hold on. Let me get on. I'll look. I'll look right now. I'll get
and
on.
Me and Chuck will have a good conversation and figure out what we should do to you if Penn State wins.
I think you got to go on the air and say, "Hi, my name is Mike Allen. I made a huge mistake." Of thinking for even a second that Penn State would lose at home in Happy Valley on homecoming when it's raining to Indiana. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm an idiot. Thank you very much. Go Lions.
And then he has to sing the song
We are head shape.
I'm not saying that. Right now, Northwestern is undefeated.
Yeah, they are. They're 5-0.
Yeah, and
won their own conference.
And they have beaten Stanford. They've beaten EIU. It's, I don't know who the hell that is. They beat Duke 19-10. Ball State from the Midwestern 24-19, and they beat Minnesota 27-0. So they're 5-0.
Yeah, well, don't hang your hat on that Minnesota win, okay?
No, I won't. Well, I'm not hanging my hat on any of those because all those, I mean, we're talking about
Stanford's record.
Outside Stanford, which was ranked 21 when they played, now I don't even think they're ranked in the top 25 anymore. Outside of Stanford.
Stanford beat what you call it, didn't they?
Yeah, but outside of Stanford, who is ranked 21st, and I don't even think they're ranked anymore, none of those teams are any good at all. Michigan opened up with Utah, who right now is on track to be the national champion. So Michigan's 4-1, but Michigan at least played a couple of people. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
Yep. Go, Chuck, you pick.
No, I'm going Michigan, 42-14.
I got to say it's not going to be a blowout what you guys think. 35-22.
Really?
13 points. Because you got to think the spread's 8. And you got to think everybody's going to jump on Michigan. And that spread might go up, too.
Oh, so you're picking Northwestern in the points.
I'm taking Michigan, but they won't win what you're thinking.
Ah, okay.
35-22, that's only 13 points. 35-20.
So you got Michigan 35-22. So you got the under, or no, you got the over, and you got, you're picking Northwestern in the points.
No, you're not missing.
Well,
Michigan's given 8. Michigan's given 8.
Okay.
Michigan will win by 13.
Ah, they're gonna, okay. So you're picking Michigan.
Yes.
Minus
the 8. It's going to be a closer game what you're thinking.
No, I don't think it's going to be close at all.
That
defense.
Mike, you want to run around naked in Michigan?
No, I'm not. You're not making me do more stuff, dude. Already,
you're saying Penn State's going to be flat. You're saying we could have a little fun.
Why is it that you want to embarrass me? What is this, Joe? What the hell?
Hey, I'm not trying to embarrass you. You're just. I think Northwestern's a great team, and well, I don't think I can't
what?
See them get blown out.
I think once Northwestern gets into the meat of the Big Ten, they're going to be exposed because they don't really play anybody. That's what I think. But hey, we got to take a break. Hey, can you guys stick around for one more segment?
I'm sorry.
Yeah, can you guys stick around for one more segment? Because we still got to get to the NFL.
Yeah, and by the way, I've got your punishment. I've got it nailed down.
All right, my punishment and NFL picks when we get back with Chuck Licata from KMAC Sports and Joe Pardini, our own prognosticator supreme, who I'm buried to fire if he makes me do any more embarrassing stuff. My goodness. Okay, mute them up, guys, and we'll come back after these messages. In less than 20 minutes, Halloween costumes. Has the PC police now invaded the sacred right for wives and girlfriends to dress up like strippers? We'll discuss with Danny Blaze. That's coming up at the top of the hour. When we come back, more of my punishment, NFL picks, and more. Right here, on the air.
Is your wife wicked hot? Or is she just cold?
Do you just want to take a hot shower?
Call Savino Mechanical for all your heating, hot water, and cooling needs. Savino Mechanical has been servicing Greater Boston and Southern New Hampshire for over a quarter century.
Quality 24-hour service,
reasonable rates, satisfaction guaranteed,
licensed and insured.
And remember, at Savino Mechanical, we are not comfortable until you are. Call Savino Mechanical today
at 1-855-624-4280.
That's 1-855-624-4280. Savino Mechanical.
Hey, everybody, this is Jimmy.
And this is Paul.
We are hosting a new show called Pod Talk.
politically offensive talk.
It's going to be about politics, religion, the presidential race, current events.
We're going to have some guests that come on, hopefully Donald Trump himself. Wishful thinking.
No, we're going to have Hillary on.
Yeah, but that would be nice. I'd love to get a hold of Hillary.
I feel like I hate fucking that.
So come and join us on Thursday nights at 11 p.m. Eastern, right after Night Talk with Joe Rocks.
Tune in every Monday and Friday night, 10 p.m. Eastern Time, for Straight Talk with Matt Haisley. Live audio on TuneIn Radio and Spreaker.com. Plus, live video on Ustream.tv. From the demented minds at ArmedRadioGlobal.com.
Crown Military Miniatures celebrates this holiday season with an enormous selection of new and vintage collector quality toy soldiers. You have to see the photorealistic detail on the World War II armor or the sheer volume of the figures from the American Civil War to the Zulu Wars to the Jacobite Rebellion. If soldiers were there, Crown Military Miniatures has it covered in little men cast in pewter. Veterans, active duty personnel, and military enthusiasts, you have to check out Crown Military Miniatures. Visit them online at crowntoysoldiers.com or visit their store at 88 North Broadway in tax-free Salem, New Hampshire.
Hi, now I know you hear Joe Rocks on their weekly restaurant reviews on Night Talk, 10 p.m. Eastern. And boy, these two like to eat, right, boys? Well, here's something to review right from your house. Eat24. That's right, eat24.com. With over 25,000 restaurants for you to choose from when you're hungry, many in your area. So review that, boys. Eat24.com. Click, order, and eat. Eat24.com.
Tune in every Monday and Friday night, 10 p.m. Eastern Time, for Straight Talk with Matt Haisley. Live audio on TuneIn Radio and Spreaker.com. Plus, live video on Ustream.tv. From the demented minds at ArmedRadioGlobal.com.
Now, back to some ass-kicking shiznit.
From Nullsoft Shoutcast.
All right, welcome back to the show. We're talking sports and football, but tonight, this show and other shows here on Armed Radio are all brought to you by the support of Eat24.com and HotSauceVault.com. Visit both of those online. For Eat24.com, you can actually download an app. What that app does is that if you put in the zip code of where you're at, they will find a restaurant near you that will deliver food to you. It's like having a food truck in your pants. It's awesome. And if you're a lover of hot sauce like I am, HotSauceVault.com is your one-stop shop for everything hot sauce. Go there, check them out. Proud sponsors of Armed Radio Global. Welcome back to the Central Texas Man Cave. And on the Ring Central Celebrity Hotline, Chuck Licata of KMAC Sports and Joe Pardini, our own very own prognosticator. Hopefully you're taking good notes. Joe is always right, by the way, which I hate. But he's good at what he does. So, unbeknownst to me, Chuck from KMAC is also from Philly, so now I'm screwed. So,
yeah, you are. You are. Okay, so you ready for your punishment?
Okay, what's my punishment, Chuck?
All right, here's my suggestion. All right. First, you have to come on the show and start one of your segments with what I said before. You have to, say, hi, my name is Mike Allen. I picked against Penn State for some stupid reason. they ended up beating Indiana on homecoming in Happy Valley. Ladies and gentlemen, my name is Mike Allen, and I'm an idiot. And then Joe and I will say, hi, Mike. But hi, Mike, right after that, that entire segment has to be talk about the NHL.
It's at the beginning of the season. I'm not going to agree to that because it's the beginning and no one cares. You got to get at least...
No, it doesn't matter.
You got to... No, you got to... Hey, with the NHL, it's like...
How long is your segment?
NHL is like the NBA and the...
How long is your segment, Mike?
Listen, the NHL is like the NBA and it's like baseball. No, listen. It's like the NHL and the and Major League Baseball. You play like 6,000 games. No one gives a crap well, until the playoffs.
That. This is your punishment, all right? Understand.
It's I know. Punishment. I got a great punishment.
No one's going to care.
How
long is your segment?
They're about 15 minutes every segment.
Oh, shit. You could sing the Penn State Alma Mater for a good 15 minutes.
I'm not singing a whole segment of Penn State. You know how many listeners I would lose? You want to kill my show?
You're the one who said Penn State would get smoked 41-0.
Yeah, pretty much.
All right, let's get back to business here.
Okay, right now.
A silly bird. All right. So let's go with the...
okay, right now. Hold on. Right now, Indiana is 4-1. The only loss coming to Ohio State, the number one team in the nation. They've beaten their opponents 48-47, 36-22, 38-35, 31-24, and they lost 34-27. So they're putting up an average of 28 points a game.
And where do they play their games?
I don't recognize half these schools. That's not the point. Stick to the point, okay?
It doesn't matter. They're playing at Penn State.
Okay. Penn State has beaten Buffalo, San Diego State University, and Army. The only game where they were command, the only game where they blew somebody out was against Rutgers, 28-3. All the rest were close. And they lost to Temple.
I know that. Who picked that the first week?
Yeah, you did. You picked that who upset. Picked that? You picked that upset. You did.
Huh?
All right. Okay, I'll say. You know what, Chuck? I'll say all that silly stuff, but there is an embargo on anything NHL until after the new year. Because it doesn't matter. Right. No one cares. Now, Chuck's all mad at me. Chuck's on the phone right now calling my replacement for Friday.
Hey, is the rookie supposed to come back? Is the freshman supposed to come back for Penn State?
Huh?
The freshman running back. Is he supposed to come back?
Oh, I don't know.
Because he's been tearing it up since, and Penn State's offense has been like a machine. When
okay, well, I'll agree to that. You guys write something up, and I'll read it live on the air. And Chuck, the other caveat to that is you have to come live in the studio.
Oh, that's cool.
For me to read that. In. Yeah.
Definitely.
Yeah, you got to sit across from me while I read it. And I'm not wearing an Eagle shirt. All right, where we got? NFL. NFL's
okay,
up.
NFL, let's go.
Where we got? Where do we got,
let's
Joe?
Let's go. All right. All right. Tomorrow night's game. Houston's giving 2 to the Colts. And remember, Andrew Luck might not play.
Well, Houston's due for a win. It's in Houston. Houston's due for a win. I think Indianapolis is the top of the AFC South right now at 2-2. Houston's 1-3, but they're due for another win. So I'm going to take the points in Houston.
No, Houston's giving the Colts 2.
Oh, they're above. Oh, I thought the Colts were favored.
No. No Andrew Luck.
Ah. Oh, yeah, I'll take the Texans. I'll take the Texans minus 2, and it'll probably be 14-7, 21-17 maybe. Because both
you're up next.
Both offenses suck, so you know there's that.
Yeah, it's going to be even worse if Andrew Luck isn't playing for the Colts. That's just going to be abysmal. And if you're a fantasy football player, you definitely want to take Frank Gore off that team. He's probably about the only guy that's going to score anything if Luck doesn't play. I'm with Mike. I think they're due for a win. I think the defense is coming around a little bit. But Indy's bad enough. I mean, I've seen them play all 3 weeks on TV, and they're
horrible.
They're nowhere near what they were last year.
Nope, they're horrible. Well, they've never really had a great defense, but they've always depended on their offense to score more points.
Yep.
And I think that's coming back to haunt them.
Kind of like my Steelers do at this point.
Yeah, I think that's coming back to haunt them. Their offense got ravaged by free agency, and when all you have left is Andrew Luck. I mean, right now they're 2-2 at the top of the South, but I don't see them hanging around that long.
No.
And it really.
No, and what I'm thinking is it's going to be close, and then the Houston defense is going to grab a turnover, return it for a touchdown, game over.
Yeah.
I'm going to say Houston 28-21.
Yeah.
I'm thinking Houston 13-10.
Yes. So low scoring. Yeah. You know, I don't know if it's just me, but outside of the New England Patriots, who are a machine right now, and it's scary, a lot of these games were just horrible. I mean, Lions lost, and I got mad, and it was a bad call, and you should never leave it in the hands of the referees anyway. But that was just a horrible game. I mean, the offense on both sides was bad. You know, I mean, and I watched the Dallas game on Sunday, and it's just bad. It's just bad football.
Yeah.
At the pro level, you'd think they'd be playing better, but
the propensity for flags nowadays is just—it's horrible.
Yeah.
They're throwing flags on every other play.
Well, they're throwing flags on every other play.
There's going to be a flag on special teams.
Yeah.
Well, God.
They're throwing too many flags, and then not good flags. I mean, that one play at the end of the Seattle-Detroit game was a no-brainer.
Oh.
It was a no-brainer. I mean, I looked at it and I said, oh, Detroit ball's on the one. I just knew Detroit was going to get the ball on the one. And then when the ball turned over, I'm like, what the hell's going on? What just happened here? How come? What? And then after the game, when basically that one old ref came out and just threw the whole refereeing crew under the bus, I thought it was awesome. That was awesome. But it cost me a TV set and my Lions lost. All right, what's the next game, Joe?
Atlanta giving 7.5 to Washington. Over and under is 47.
I'll take this one. It's real simple. It's going to be Atlanta. Give the points. And Atlanta's going to score 42 to 45 points themselves. They're going to kick the living crap out of Washington.
Yeah, Atlanta's right
absolutely
now sitting
positively.
Sitting 4-0. They're averaging 28 points a game. They've beat the Eagles 26-24. That was the only close game. Well, the Giants 24-20, 39-28 over the Cowboys, and they just shellacked the Texans. It's 48-21, but it was 48-7 going into the last part of the fourth quarter, and they pulled all their starters. So. Yeah, I'm going to have to go with the Atlanta Falcons on this. And the points. And the over. What's the over and under?
47.
I'll take the over.
And what's the score?
What about you, Joe?
I'd say it's going to... Atlanta will win by 13. It's going to be like 13.
I was thinking 45-21.
Because Washington, you like we talked on the phone. You said Cousins, it's coming around.
Yeah, but the Washington defense isn't gonna stop Atlanta.
And Washington is coming off a rival game with the Eagles, so can't see them stay close.
No, I don't either. I don't either. I think it's gonna be a blowout. All right, what's the next game?
Kansas City Chiefs giving 9 to the Bears.
I'll take that. Because the Bears suck. They're horrible.
And the over and under is 45.
I take the over.
Score?
Thirty-five, twenty-one.
Yeah, that'd be 11. Go ahead.
Is Cutler playing?
Right, Chuck.
I think Cutler is playing. No, he's out.
Is he out again?
Yeah, let me check. Let me check.
Okay. While you're checking, fancy 31 on Chicago is Martellus Bennett, the tight end. He'll score, no question.
So right now,
I think Kansas City beats the spread, whether Cutler's playing or not. If Cutler doesn't play, then they take the over, but it's going to be a 21-24 point blowout. If Cutler does play, they keep it within 14.
Cutler's day to day with a hamstring.
Oh,
and he limited participant in practice today on the 7th. So you're 4 days out from game day, and he's limited practice.
Last
week?
What they do last week? I think they lost by a lot.
And what was the score?
Hold on, let me look. Actually, it was a close game. They beat the Raiders 22-20.
Yep.
Yeah, they came back and beat them.
So, after that win, I got to go with the Chiefs by 14. 28-14.
Yeah, Chiefs have had some hard luck, but they're a good football team.
Yeah, they're very good. Alex Smith is probably one of the most underrated quarterbacks next to Andy Dalton in the NFL.
Yeah, I agree. I agree with that. I agree.
Three more games, Michael.
All right, well, hurry up. Well, we're at the end of the segment.
All right, because our guest is a Steeler fan, so we have to put him in the Steelers.
All right.
So,
okay, one more, Steelers.
The Chargers. What?
One more.
Three more.
One more. We're at the end of the segment, brother.
Oh, geez, I want to get my Eagles in.
See,
y'all want to
see, because we wasted 5 minutes arguing about hockey. See what hockey does? See what hockey does in the fall?
We got a picture of punishment. All right, Chargers give it 3 to the Steelers. Monday nighter.
Monday night Chargers. Okay, go ahead.
45. Over and under is 45.
Well, this is one of those games where you think, okay, Pittsburgh is down, Chargers, have a good offense, but this is, the Steelers play best in primetime. No question. They may not win in primetime, but they play best in primetime. Now, so I'm going to go with the Steelers. Give me the points with the Steelers. As far as the over-under, I'm going to go under. Because Michael Vick just doesn't know that offense, and the good news is Martavis Bryant is back for the Steelers, so they've got too many threats to pass to, and even Vic can't screw that up.
And what's the over-under?
45.
I'll take the over and the points.
What's the score?
No, I mean, what's the points? What's the spread?
The Chargers are giving 3.
I'll take the Chargers minus 3. Final score, 32-14.
I say Chargers. The Chargers will win 27-24. It's a push.
Really?
And I'm going to take the over.
Okay.
What's your Eagles game real quick? Hurry up. Come on, get it in. What's the Eagles game?
Come on, let's get the Eagles game.
All right, real quick.
Give it 5 to Saints.
Where are they playing?
It's in Philly.
I got the Saints minus 5. I got the... What's the over and under?
Oh, I want to hear this score. I want to hear this one.
I got the Saints 14-7.
Oh.
So I'll take the under.
The under's 49.
Yeah.
Yeah, I got the under. Definitely under. Yep.
Because even Drew Brees in his heyday, or in his best this year, Brandon Cooks, everybody was drafting him for their fantasy teams, and they're getting blown away right now. Gosh, I could see 17-10. and either team winning. But since it's in Philly, and since I met my new Philly brother, I'll go with Philly in this one, 17-10.
I go with my Eagles 28-14.
28-14,
all right. Sam Bradford, hey, we got to get Mike Detroit in, and they were out of here.
You don't
You're
have
Detroit.
To. I've given up already.
Arizona,
we're already fighting for the number one draft point.
Arizona's giving Detroit 3.
Oh.
I'll take Detroit plus the 3. Actually, no. I'll take Detroit plus 21.
That's a teaser.
Give me the 21. What's the over and under? What's the over and under?
44.
I'll take the over. No, I got to go with my boys, man. I'll take it straight up, Detroit.
I got to go with you on this one, Mike.
Detroit's got, they're mad. They're angry. God, but it's the Arizona Cardinals. Oh, shoot. God, they're good.
It's in Detroit.
Yeah, but these are the games that Detroit wins. And then they'll go lose to Jacksonville. All right, I'll take Detroit. I'll take the points in Detroit and the under.
Go ahead, Chuck.
Hate to do with Mike, but I've got to go with Arizona. This is too much. Too much of a one-sided game. Give me Arizona by 10. They'll be up 21 early, and Detroit will come back and make it a close game. Give me 31-20.
31-20? All right.
Yeah.
Well, good deal.
I need to know, did Calvin Johnson beat that record yet?
I don't know, but we are out of time. I'm way late into my break. Guys, thank you so much.
He will kill us all.
Thank you so much for joining us, Joe. It's always a pleasure. We will see you next week. Chuck, the invitation stands if you'd like to come actually into the man cave. I think
absolutely.
I'm actually.
We'll take advantage of that.
I think I'm right.
I appreciate
up the,
that.
I think we're right up the street from each other anyway. So.
Yep.
We are Penn State.
Right
on, brother.
All right. Thanks, guys.
Peace, Joe.
Thanks, guys.
See you later, my friend.
All right. See you later. That's Chuck Licata from K-Max Sports and our own Joe Pardini. We're way late, and I'm going to play just a couple of commercials here. To get us through the top of the hour, and Danny Blaze has already entered the man cave. She's not smiling or anything, so she's tired. We got to get her riled up. I'm Mike Allen. This is the Armed Radio Global Network, and you are on the air. Be right back.
Night's Talk with Joe Rocks. 10 p.m. Eastern, Thursdays, is now on Ustream TV. Spreaker for replays and live. On Live 365, exclusively on Armed Radio Global.
Joe Rocks, it's Louis Avis straight from Chi-Town. Come on and talk about our website, www.hotsaucevault.com. We got everything you can think of out there, Joe. The hottest hot sauce is not for wimps. Mild, medium sauces. We got barbecue sauces, snacks. Some of our gift ideas and gag gifts, so you can go out and check us out at www.hotsaucevault.com. Hope to talk to you again on your radio show. Kick-ass show. Had a great time last week. Hope to hear from you soon. Take care, Joe. Hotsaucevault.com.
Hi, now I know you hear Joe Rocks on their weekly restaurant reviews on Night Talk, 10 p.m. Eastern. And boy, these two like to eat, right, boys? Well, here's something to review right from your house. Eat24. That's right, eat24.com. With over 25,000 restaurants for you to choose from when you're hungry, many in your area. So review that, boys. Eat24.com. Click, order, and eat. Eat24.com.
Crown Military Miniatures celebrates this holiday season with an enormous selection of new and vintage collector quality toy soldiers. You have to see the photorealistic detail on the World War II armor or the sheer volume of the figures from the American Civil War to the Zulu Wars to the Jacobite Rebellion. If soldiers were there, Crown Military Miniatures has it covered in little men cast in pewter. Veterans, active duty personnel, and military enthusiasts, you have to check out Crown Military Miniatures. Visit them online at crowntoysoldiers.com or visit their store at 88 North Broadway in tax-free Salem, New Hampshire.
Are you a gamer? A girl gamer at that? If you're looking for the best hangout point to discuss games, then the right place for you is joystickgirls.com. Meet new gamers, discuss topics, and share hints and tips. Now looking for new members. So sign up today at the new site that keeps getting better and better. JoystickGirls.com.
Armed Radio Global presents its new 2015 Talk at Night lineup.
Mondays, 8 p.m. Eastern. Spot on with Lino and Tom.
Straight Talk with Matt Haisley. Mondays and Fridays, 10 p.m. Eastern.
On Tuesdays, Talk Time with Val, 8 p.m. Eastern, followed by High Five at 10 p.m. Eastern with Johnny and Mikey.
Wednesdays on the air with Mike Allen, 10 p.m. EST. And Thursdays, Night Talk with Joe Rocks, 10 p.m. Eastern.
Join the talk now on Ustream TV. Replays on Spring. Exclusively on Armed Radio Global.
Cell 2G 2000 watts. Yeah, yeah.
Never met thing in my bedroom. Never met
Alright, welcome back. It's that time, it's the witching hour, and we are way late into this segment, and I do apologize to all the listeners out there who cannot wait for Miss Danny Blaze to grace the airwaves with her insights.
At least I can say the F word.
Her wit. Yeah, the views and opinions viewed tonight, or expressed tonight by Miss Danny Blaze, are not the views and opinions of Armed Radio Global.
But they should be.
Studio 6 Entertainment. Basically, if your kids are up listening to the show right now, put them to bed. You're a responsible parent.
Or come stop back. Buying your 7-year-old a smartphone.
Stop buying your 7-year-old a smartphone with access to all this fun stuff. And hopefully you have passwords to everything. Tonight is brought to you by eat24.com. Download the app from iTunes or Google Play. Put it on your phone. Put the zip code of where you're at in your phone. They will find a restaurant near you that will deliver food to you. It's like having a food truck. Where, Danny?
In your pants.
In your pants. And hotsaucevault.com. I tell you, if you like hot sauce, that's the place to go. Hotsaucevault.com. For all our new listeners that have just now joined us, welcome. And now it's time for Miss Danny Blaze.
So what am I yelling about first? Some lady that's mad that somebody spray painted to look like a different race on Halloween?
The political correctness of Halloween costumes.
Okay. Well, if anyone knows anything about anything, which apparently people don't, Halloween started. The Celtics actually started Halloween from all the history
the
of Halloween.
The Celts or the Celtics?
Whatever, the Celtics, whatever. Yeah, the basketball team started it.
The basketball team started it. Okay. We have a caller calling in. Well, go ahead. Keep talking, Danny.
I'm good.
It's Blanche, so she'll wait.
I know who it is.
Matt.
Hold on. Let Danny finish her thought. Go ahead. The Celtics?
Whatever. They started Halloween. They did it because they celebrate their New Year on November 1st, so they had Hallows Eve, which turned into Halloween, and they did it because the reason they celebrated on the 1st is because that's when the seasons changed and all the crops died and it became winter. Symbolized dead bodies. They would wear masks of animal heads, typically, to ward off the spirits of the evil dead before. So when you are portraying yourself to be another thing or another race, that's kind of the point of Halloween.
And you don't think it's offensive?
No, I just think people need something to cry about. You have no problems in your life, so somebody else spray painting their face. If somebody's spray painting their face white, I'm not going to be offended. I don't give a shit. Why is that offensive? It's offensive because you make it offensive because you need something to cry about because everyone nowadays is a victim.
Danny Place.
Boom. Like, hello? Like, you don't even know anything about Halloween. Halloween is not dressing up like a slutty kitty.
Hush your mouth right now.
But that's not what Halloween's about. So technically this person that's portraying themselves to be something else. Yeah,
remember, the views and opinions of Danny Blaze do not reflect the views and...
I find it offensive that people dress like slutty nuns, and I'm not even religious. But that's weird.
That is kind of weird.
It is, right?
But slutty kitties.
Yeah, all cats are sluts.
Pretty much. Or slutty cowboys.
Slutty anything, but slutty nun, I mean, slutty, I'm not even religious or anything at all, and I'm like, that's even kind of...
Snow White.
Kind of weird. No one's on a fit about slutty nuns, but some black lady wants to be mad that somebody's spray-painting themselves to look black, and now all of a sudden she's a fucking racist.
Actually, the lady that was upset was white.
God, stop apologizing for shit you had nothing to part of. That's what she needs to stop doing. Why is that offensive to her? Why is it offensive? If I want to dress up like a bear on Halloween, you don't think a bunch of Smokey the Bears are going to come cruising the streets protesting. Like, stop being offended by stupid shit that doesn't have anything to do with you. If I dress up like a fat bald man, do you think a bunch of fat bald men are going to show up at the door like, hey, that's really offensive? No. God, race is so stupid. Race is what you make it. Yeah, there's racism, sure, but just because somebody spray prints themselves doesn't mean they're fucking being racist. And why somebody that has nothing to do with that particular race is offended blows my mind.
So what if I put on a turban and strap red-colored toilet paper rolls like in a vest, like a bomb vest, and I go as Al-Qaeda? Would that be offensive to Arabs?
Probably. Who fucking knows? Actually, I don't think they would. They'd be like, oh, come join our side. It's Halloween. Halloween is for dress up and make believe and pretending and to, if you practice actual Halloween practices, then it is to ward off evil spirits by putting on masks and costumes to scare off demons. So if anything, they should be applauding her for doing such a thing.
So joining us on the Ring Central Celebrity Hotline and not in the man cave where she needs to be smelling up this place like flowers and letting Danny give her big hugs. It's Miss Blanche Beauregard. What do you think, Blanche? What do you think about all this?
Well, Mike, I'm getting an echo, and I don't know why that is. Can you fix that for me, sugar?
I don't know why you'd get an echo.
Okay, well, now I feel better. I'm actually just calling to tell you that I have a gentleman friend in from out of town, and we're busy playing cards or playing poker, and I can't talk. I can't talk about Halloween. I can't play dress up because I'm playing strip poker. I'm undressing, so I don't have time to talk. Actually, we're not playing strip poker. I'm just being silly about that. We're not doing anything like that. We're having a nice game of bridge and just playing.
So you're playing poker or bridge?
What did I say? Poker. We're playing poker. He's going to poker later. But anyway, so I can't talk. I just called to tell you.
So you just called to tell us that you can't?
I can't talk. I have a gentleman friend, and he is a gentleman, and we're just playing cards, and I can't talk. That's all. I just wanted to let you know.
Ms. Blanche, is he giving you the vapors?
He doesn't get nobody. It takes quite a man to give me the vapors.
Well, you said I gave you the. You said I gave you the vapors.
No.
Oh, so that story changes. That story changes.
Blanche is starting to come to bed.
Oh, I gotta go. I've got a full house. Yeah. He's giving me a royal flush. I gotta go. I told you I couldn't talk. I'm playing cards.
All right, Blanche.
Now, Miss Danny, I do love you, sugar, and I'm so proud of you for not wanting to be a slutty nut when you grow up. That's very good thing.
Yeah, give me the Nobel Peace Prize.
All right, I gotta go. Somebody, the King of Hearts, is just dealing me a nice little hand. Ooh.
All right.
Bye. Love y'all.
By Blanche Beauregard. Ms. Blanche Beauregard. Getting the vapors.
Blanche Beauregard was on Scooby-Doo, by the way.
Really?
Yeah.
Is that where that character name came from?
I don't know if that's where it came from, but I remember there being a Blanche Beauregard on Scooby-Doo. So,
You are tired. You took a nap today.
I took a long nap. I've had my period for 3 weeks now, so no one can tell me shit.
You still going?
Yeah, I'm still.
Oh, my God.
Bleeding out slowly. So, if anyone should not trust anything that's coming
out
of my mouth.
So, we still have to worry about bears.
Yep, all the bears. See? Are you offended? You should be offended that I'm putting your life at risk.
At risk of bears.
Not because I... So, if I wear a black hood, is that offensive to Trayvon Martin's family? If I wear a black hoodie?
I don't know.
Probably, because people want to be mad about nothing. Like, how sad is your life that you just have to make shit up to be pissed off about?
That is true. That's pretty much Facebook, though, isn't it?
Yeah, basically.
People putting stuff in their statuses and then getting mad when people comment about stuff they put in their statuses, talking about it's none of your business. Well, if it's none of my business, why did you put it
status? See, you have people that are being mad over people spray painting their face, and then you have women that are creating things called the dildo selfie stick. Those are the real MVPs.
I tell you what, we're going to talk about the dildo selfie stick because you talked to me about this earlier today and we were discussing show topics and I've got to know.
It's a real thing.
I've got to know.
There's a website. You can go to it. It has an instructional video that's very unappealing.
Oh, my God. All right. We'll be back after these messages with more of Danny Blaze and the dildo selfie stick. I'm Mike Allen. This is the Armed Radio Global Network and you're on the air.
Route 106 Motors is the home of fine pre-owned vehicles. Experience a no-pressure sale with a family-friendly atmosphere. Route 106 Motors has been practicing the same simple philosophy of low prices for over a decade, and it has brought us great success. Recently, while other dealers are closing their doors, Route 106 Motors is expanding. We are a wholesale dealer, and we own the property and pay cash for all the vehicles. This allows us to sell to the consumer for a lot less than the average dealership. We are a high-volume, small-profit dealer, and we pass the savings on to you. New changes have been made at Route 106 Motors. Stop by and check out our brand-new building. Route 106 Motors, located at 569 West Street. Check our website at Route106Motors.com and be sure to like us on Facebook to find out about all the latest deals and savings opportunities. Route106Motors.com.
Hi, now I know you hear Joe Rocks on their weekly restaurant reviews on Night Talk, 10 p.m. Eastern. And boy, these two like to eat, right, boys? Well, here's something to review right from your house. Eat24. That's right, eat24.com. With over 25,000 restaurants for you to choose from when you're hungry, many in your area. So review that, boys. Eat24.com. Click, order, and eat. Eat24.com.
Crown Military Miniatures celebrates this holiday season with an enormous selection of new and vintage collector quality toy soldiers. You have to see the photorealistic detail on the World War II armor or the sheer volume of the figures from the American Civil War to the Zulu Wars to the Jacobite Rebellion. If soldiers were there, Crown Military Miniatures has it covered in little men cast in pewter. Veterans, active duty personnel, and military enthusiasts, you have to check out Crown Military Miniatures. Visit them online at crowntoysoldiers.com or visit their store at 88 North Broadway in tax-free Salem, New Hampshire.
Hey, Joe Rocks. It's Louis Avis straight from Chi-Town. Come on and talk about our website, www.hotsaucevault.com. We got everything you can think of out there, Joe. The hottest hot sauce is not for wimps. Mild, medium sauces. We got barbecue sauces, snacks, some of our gift ideas and gag gifts. So you can go out and check us out at www.hotsaucevault.com. Hope to talk to you again on your radio show. Kick-ass show. Had a great time last week. Hope to hear from you soon. Take care, Joe. Hotsaucevault.com.
Are you ready to take your webpage to the next level? Go to icegram.com and download for free all the tools you will need to enhance your webpage content for potential customers, clients, or fans. Capture leads, call your audience to action, skyrocket conversation and engagement with action bars, pop-ups, toast notifications, message boxes, overlays, and sidebars. Head on over to icegram.com for your free download. That's icegram.com.
Bottom line, you'll love it.
Hey there, all you creepy people. This is Kevin Wayne from Portland, Oregon. You're listening to Armed Radio, home of the big guns.
Tune in every Monday and Friday night, 10 p.m. Eastern Time, for Straight Talk with Matt Haisley. Live audio on TuneIn Radio and Spreaker.com. Plus, live video on Ustream.tv. From the demented minds at armedradioglobal.com.
Cell 2G, 2000 watts. Yeah.
All right, welcome back to the show. Tonight's broadcast brought to you by E24.com. I've been talking about them all night long. If you haven't downloaded the app yet, well, you just suck at life. Download the app from either iTunes or Google Play. Put in the zip code of where you're at. They'll find a restaurant near you that will deliver food to you. It's like having a food truck in your pants. Also, hotsaucevault.com. If you like hot sauce, like I like hot sauce, go to hotsaucevault.com for all your hot sauce needs. Deliver it right to your store. Welcome back. In the Armed Radio Global Central Texas Man Cave, Ms. Danny Place.
So, dildo selfie sticks. On my vast searches through the internet, I find a bunch of random shit like dildo selfie sticks. So, apparently, this woman decided that.
What does it look like? Is the dildo
it's a selfie stick
with a dildo on it
at the end. So, the dildo's here, and then the selfie stick goes up, so that way. Camera's facing you.
As you
use the dildo to capture the perfect O face, because apparently a lot of people are struggling with being able to do that
without the dildo selfie stick.
But she did have a good part of her video explaining it was that you can interchange them. So they come in with like it's like a screw on, basically, and you can change it to different ones.
So if...
Because, you know, most people...
I don't know. I've never used a dildo, so I don't know what the... you know, I don't know what you're looking for in a dildo.
Well, that depends on the lady. I think most women have a pretty good lockdown on what they want in a rubber penis.
So
pretty much you can... change it, and then with the click of a button, you can capture the perfect O face. The video is hilarious, and the girl is.
It actually has a video of somebody using it?
I mean, it doesn't show.
But it uses the camera view of her O face, right?
Yeah, like it watches her. Oh, it's like a fake. You can tell it's a fake one, but.
Oh, so she acts it out.
No, she's not actually using an
O face.
No, she's just acting it out for the instructional video.
Ah.
So, I thought that was pretty cool. Another interesting thing that I found...
What's that link?
DildoSelfieStick.com. It's a very bland website. It's pretty much just the video. I don't even know if you can actually buy it or not. But I'm pretty sure you can stick a dildo to pretty much anything.
Mm-hmm.
So, for selfie sticks, if you use the hollow strap-on dildos, it would fit on the handle. And then you'd be able to interchange them, as long as they had a hole at the bottom.
Oh, so it's just a... Oh, it's just on YouTube, basically.
Yeah.
What if you could capture one of life's greatest moments with the push of a button? Say hello to the dildo selfie stick. It's the first selfie stick that you can actually, well, stick it. When it's pleasure time, simply extend the dildo selfie stick and get down to business. At the moment of climax, simply push the button to capture your O-face. The dildo selfie stick also lets you attach many of your other favorite toys. Want to share your O-face? Get the dildo selfie stick and stick it up your...
Is that not the most solid video ever?
I'm sorry. That was great.
I love how monotone she stays through the whole video.
Yeah.
But, you know, I was thinking about it. Anatomically, the way you would have to stick the dildo in you would get the shittiest camera angle for your O-face. No one would want to see that. And I actually don't think a lot of women want to actually see what they look like. Because most of the time, if it's real, it's not that pretty. It's not like porn.
No.
If anyone was confused. I mean, sure, some people. I have not seen every single woman in the whole entire planet have an orgasm, so I really don't have anything to go off of, but... Yeah, no. If you're doing it right, it's usually some weird contortion, devil-looking shit, so... She has time to take a selfie.
Well, that's what I was thinking. I mean, if you... When you're actually having the O...
You're not going to have time to hit a button on a selfie stick.
Or even concentrate enough to do it.
But...
You'd think, right?
On the flip side, for long-distance relationships, that would be good for...
Like Skyping.
Recording video.
Like Skyping.
Yeah, because you could just open up Skype on the stick and it would just keep going.
Yeah, on
you
your don't phone.
Go nothing. While you, you know, handled your business. But another invention that this guy is trying to get on the market, I think his name was Brian Sloan. It's called the 3FAP. And it's a little square box. How about? Like a foot by a foot. There's videos on that. So pretty much it's a 3-in-1 male masturbator machine. So one's a mouth, one's a vagina, one's a butt. Each has a different inside. But the different thing about this is that, one, they're all connected. And two, you can control the suction on each individual one. So while
this is on YouTube?
I'm not sure where I found the video. If you type in 3FAP, it pops up.
The number 3?
Yeah. But, unlike a fleshlight, you can control the suction on them, so. I feel like that would, I guess, give more of a lifelike.
Oh, it's a sing-along. Hold on, we got...
Oh, yeah, that video is hilarious. I watched a sing-along earlier. They have normal video, too.
It says FAP happier. All right, this is the 3FAP.
It's actually a pretty cool
machine. So it's got
machine.
The... So I'm looking at it.
Butt, mouth, and vagina.
It's got the butt, the vagina, and the mouth. Okay.
Here's... And each inside is different.
Yeah.
Your strokers and sleeves are getting mundane. Your todger is begging for a wider range. 3 levels of suction, 3 textures to ooze on, and 3 different orifices to choose from. 3FAP, 3FAP, the fun's not so low. 3FAP, 3FAP, switch between holes, bro. 3FAP, 3FAP, your monster's cheering for this to rhyme for engineering. 3FAP, FAP happier.
Okay, you got way too much time.
So this guy's trying to raise money to make this like an actual product.
Oh, he's doing...
So this is an actual thing. So he has like legit videos.
Hold on, yeah, he's got another video here. Come here, Alex.
No, I'm all right.
I already told him about it.
He's like, no, we're good.
Hi, I'm Brian Sloan, and this... is 3FAP. 3FAP is the new 3-in-1 sex toy for men that's gonna make fap time.
I like the stuff he's pulling back.
Look at how quick and easy it is to use. You just open the case, put in the sleeve, fap. If you're still using this old stuff, your penis is in prison, and 3FAP is your way out. 3FAP gives you 3
holes
to choose
from. You wouldn't
want to
have your penis in prison.
This is the mouth, vulva, anus prototype, but we're also gonna make 3 mouths. 3 vulvas, 3 anuses, and all kinds of other combinations. 3FAP's 3 openings will have you experiencing 3 different textures.
Oh, then it's got the internal camera.
Put it in your butt. It's tight and smooth. Put it in the vagina. It's ribbed. Put it in the mouth. It's a zigzag pattern. 3FAP will let you independently control the suction level of each orifice using these dials. Try doing that.
It's not a bad product.
You know, it's my birthday today.
3FAP.
Well, it's not an actual product, so therefore.
Highly detailed 3D scanning to make the orifice.
Did you contact him to be on the show?
I recently held a worldwide.
Couldn't find his information where. The only reason I know it's not a real product yet is because I found where the site where he was trying to raise money.
Oh, the what do they call him? The
of the 6 winners.
It was like a
GoFundMe type thing.
It was like that, yeah, but it was not.
All right, so I got 3FAP. This guy. This guy, I mean, you gotta see the guy.
He looks like he would invent three
like,
fap.
Yeah, he looks like he would invent three fap.
But think about it, that's a product that's not out there. Now they have like really expensive male masturbators that are rechargeable or battery powered that can do different things.
Well, if I'm gonna spend that kind of money, you just buy the real though.
Those are like thousands of dollars.
Yeah, like $4,000.
This is like 100 or 2.
Yeah, I know, but for $4,000 one time, don't have to pay anything else, don't have to keep paying for dinner and putting up with years of frustration.
I think it's Lilo that makes it, but it's a male masturbator, and you just like put your finger on it on the top, and it changes the different vibrations and suctions on it. So that one's like really fancy, but that one's like 200 and something bucks. But it's rechargeable, so you never have to buy batteries again. Which is a lot cheaper than dinner.
It's true.
I thought it was a cool product, actually, because there's not one like that out there. And I'm sure there's lots of lonely men that will help fund that. Because you get three different orifices. I think the original article that I read was how to please your man in every way or something. So I was like, oh, here we go. Some bullshit like sex tip advice. Nope, it was that. And I was like, oh, don't be there at all. Just buy him male masturbators and he'll be fine. So, I don't know. The dildo selfie stick, I could see where that could... I think the way she executed it was not very great, but I could see how that product would be very popular. 3-in-1... controllable suction on a male masturbator. That shit's gonna sell like hotcakes if it makes it to
production.
Yeah. Well, apparently, what he did for the sleeves was he used a 3D printer for the inside part, for the different ridges, and I didn't know the inside of mouths were zigzagged, but you know, whatever. I just don't get how they're very realistic feeling. Like all the ones that claim to be realistic.
Mm-hmm.
Also, a thing that people did not believe was real was the alien dildo that could implant eggs into you. Fake eggs, obviously, but...
Why would you want to put eggs?
Apparently people get off to being artificially inseminated.
Inseminated by alien?
By an alien, yeah. So it's a very alien-like looking penis, and then you just load the eggs through the back of it, and then they will deposit into you. Apparently that gets people off. So between dildo selfie sticks, three fat machines, and alien dicks, I don't know what's happening to the world. All this shit's... You can buy an alien dick, and
well, first of all, how does somebody know what an alien dick looks like?
Because aliens are real and the government's hiding them. Because the aliens own us.
They're running the government? Is that what you're saying?
Yeah, they're paying them off like crooked cops. It's like the drug lords paying off crooked cops. They're like, hey, you know about this. We're going to keep them down now and watch all these stupid ass people. We don't know what happened with our experiment. Just run around like a bunch of jackasses being mad about race. And Halloween. So the aliens would kick back drinking alien beer. I don't know what aliens drink to get drunk. But
probably not the good stuff.
They're drinking that.
You know what I think is a sad testament? Is we have the Three Fap jingle song on vinyl. Have No Fear, Three Fap is here on tigerdroppings.com. So that's the Tiger Droppings is a thing. But on the first page of Google, at the very bottom, it says the Book of Common Prayer with notes. When you search the three fap. So well, someone out there is trying to save you while you go to hell.
For fapping?
Sticking your penis into a fake vagina.
I don't know. Wouldn't God rather you do that than like put it in like a real one? Yeah, you know, before
I mean, you'd think. Well,
that.
There's some religions that believe that just by the act of masturbating is a sin.
Well, if I didn't know I was going to hell already.
I think it's the Catholic. I think it's the Catholic religion. There's the one that's against all forms of birth control because and abstinence and all that all that kind of stuff. I think they're the ones that are hardcore with that.
Unless you go to confessional and confess your sins, then you're free.
Yeah.
So, in theory, you can do whatever you want. You just have to tell some old man about it. And then you are set free to the righteous land. Oh, no. I've only been in confessional once, and all I said was to him was, hey, I thought God can see everything I do. And he was like, he can. I'm like, so why do I have to tell you? He already knows what the hell I'm doing. Why do I need to announce it to you? Because I don't have enough time in the day to tell you everything that you consider a sin that I've done.
So what do you say?
He's just like, oh, well, I was like, all right, so I'm just going to go now. The only reason I went is because my great-grandpa died, and my great-grandma was like, you need to go, and mom. And it was like, you know, the whole Catholic production. So I was like, okay.
Now, that's on your German side family, right?
Mexican side.
Oh, the okay. Father-in-law. All right.
No, German side, not religious, but...
About nothing.
About nothing.
Now, father's side is Mormon. Mormon.
Fuck me, man. Stepmom side, too.
And that's...
They don't.
That's a whole other show topic right there.
That's a couple show topic. I mean, just, you know, my thing about the Mormon religion, though, is that they're crazy. Everyone knows they're fucking crazy. And they just sit in their little family homes with their 17 kids, not shopping on Sundays, not drinking, not shaving.
Wearing their special jammies?
Magic jammies. Which, in Utah... Certain stores that sell them, you cannot go into that store to purchase them unless you have a signed card from your church saying you are in fact a Mormon and you can go in there and buy them. My aunt had took me and my brother shopping and we had to wait outside because obviously we're not a part of the church.
Mm-hmm.
And I was like, what kind of shit is this? And has anyone ever seen their temples? I mean, the gawkiest shit I've ever seen in my life. I'm like... You can't shop on Sundays, but you have this big-ass gold Jesus that I can see from an airplane. Is this real life? I mean, it's so obnoxious. When my aunt got married, me and my mom couldn't go in the church.
Couldn't go in the church when they got married? Wow.
Nope, because we are not a part of the church.
Now, I did get approached by a mission and went in the church. But we'll talk about that when we come back. Stick around. Danny Blaze is in the man cave, and we're discussing stuff.
We're
saying words with our mouths. And if you want to stick around for the last segment, you may. I will allow you. You are allowed in here with your special jammies.
Yeah, you don't need no cards.
Don't need no card or nothing.
Unless you want to pay my bills, then you can have a card.
Are you a gamer? A girl gamer at that? If you're looking for the best hangout point to discuss games, then the right place for you is joystickgirls.com. Meet new gamers, discuss topics, and share hints and tips. Now looking for new members. So sign up today at the new site that keeps getting better and better, joystickgirls.com.
Route 106 Motors is the home of fine pre-owned vehicles. Experience a no-pressure sale with a family-friendly atmosphere. Route 106 Motors has been practicing the same simple philosophy of low prices for over a decade, and it has brought us great success. Recently, while other dealers are closing their doors, Route 106 Motors is expanding. We are a wholesale dealer, and we own the property and pay cash for all the vehicles. This allows us to sell to the consumer for a lot less than the average dealership. We are a high-volume, small-profit dealer, and we pass the savings on to you. New changes have been made at Route 106 Motors. Stop by and check out our brand new building. Route 106 Motors, located at 569 West Street. Check our website at Route106Motors.com and be sure to like us on Facebook to find out about all the latest deals and savings opportunities. Route106Motors.com.
Hi, now I know you hear Joe Rocks on their weekly restaurant reviews on Night Talk, 10 p.m. Eastern. And boy, these two like to eat, right, boys? Well, here's something to review right from your house. Eat24. That's right, eat24.com. With over 25,000 restaurants for you to choose from when you're hungry, many in your area. So review that, boys. Eat24.com. Click, order, and eat. Eat24.com.
Crown Military Miniatures celebrates this holiday season with an enormous selection of new and vintage collector quality toy soldiers. You have to see the photorealistic detail on the World War II armor or the sheer volume of the figures from the American Civil War to the Zulu Wars to the Jacobite Rebellion. If soldiers were there, Crown Military Miniatures has it covered in little men cast in pewter. Veterans, active duty personnel, and military enthusiasts, you have to check out Crown Military Miniatures. Visit them online at crowntoysoldiers.com or visit their store at 88 North Broadway in tax-free Salem, New Hampshire.
Hey, Joe Rocks. It's Louis Avis straight from Chi-Town. Come on and talk about our website, www.hotsaucevault.com. We got everything you can think of out there, Joe. The hottest hot sauce is not for wimps. Mild, medium sauces. We got barbecue sauces, snacks, some of our gift ideas and gag gifts. So you can go out and check us out at www.hotsaucevault.com. Hope to talk to you again on your radio show. Kick-ass show. Had a great time last week. Hope to hear from you soon. Take care, Joe. Hotsaucevault.com.
Are you ready to take your webpage to the next level? Go to icegram.com and download for free all the tools you will need to enhance your webpage content for potential customers, clients, or fans. Capture leads, call your audience to action, skyrocket conversation and engagement with action bars, pop-ups, toast notifications, message boxes, overlays, and sidebars. Head on over to icegram.com for your free download. That's icegram.com. Bottom line, you'll love it.
Tune in every Monday and Friday night, 10 p.m. Eastern Time, for Straight Talk with Matt Haisley.
Live audio on TuneIn Radio and Spreaker.com.
Plus live video on Ustream.tv. From the demented minds at ArmedRadioGlobal.com.
Hey there, all you creepy people. This is Kevin Wayne from Portland, Oregon. You're listening to Armed Radio, home of the big guns.
Armed Radio Global presents its new 2015 Talk at Night lineup.
Mondays, 8 p.m. Eastern. Spot on with Lino and Tom.
Straight Talk with Matt Haisley. Mondays and Fridays, 10 p.m. Eastern.
On Tuesdays, Talk Time with Val, 8 p.m. Eastern, followed by High Five at 10 p.m. Eastern with Johnny and Mikey.
Wednesdays on the air with Mike Allen, 10 p.m. EST. And Thursdays, Night Talk with Joe Rocks, 10 p.m. Eastern.
Join the talk now on Ustream TV.
Replays on Spring.
Exclusively on Armed Radio Global.
Cell 2G 2000 watts. Yeah, yeah.
Never meant taking in my bed.
Do you want to talk about our sponsors?
Is it
soe24.com?
Yep. All right, e24.com. Go to your iTunes Store, your Google Play, and download the free app for e24.com. Put in your zip code. They will find a restaurant close to you that will deliver. It's like having a food truck in your pants, and it's delicious. And then Hot Sauce Vault, which is a super awesome website where you can go order all kinds of delicious, spicy, mild, crazy, not crazy hot sauces, and they will deliver it to you. Hot Sauce Vault. It's like having a
hot sauce in your hot sauce.
It's like having a pepper in your pants. Hot sauce bowl. Although, now that I said that, no one really wants a pepper in their pants. Hot sauce bowl is like having a wonderful pepper in your pants.
You can't save it. So what were we talking about?
You being approached by a missionary.
Oh, yeah.
Religion.
So I was invited to the Church of Latter-day Saints, and I went.
Yeah, that happened to my grandma. She used to party before she did that.
And I went in and sat down. And apparently, when you're... I don't know what the word is for those that are not part of the church yet.
Sinners?
Okay. No, they got a word for it.
I have no idea.
Anyway, I was allowed in because the guy that was inviting me was a high priest. But apparently I'm not supposed to say anything to anyone. Okay, no one told me this when I walk in. So I'm like, hey, what's going on? How you doing? My name's Mark. And they're like, oh, no, you can't. You can't talk. You can't address anybody of the church. And I was like, what the hell kind of...
I went to church with my grandma when I was little, and that, I felt like I was in there for like 4 hours. I mean, I walked out of there like on the verge of tears. I was like, this is the most boring, saddest day of my whole entire life.
So, was she trying to get you part of the church?
Well, of course she wants her grandbabies to be, because me, my brother, my stepbrother, and stepsister are pretty much the only grandkids that don't get forced to practice that. Now, some of my family is not like, shove it down your throat. They invite us to church, but I always tell them no, because that shit's boring, but they're not like, annoying. My grandma's not like that so much anymore, because now the only ones that don't practice that religion are old enough to tell her to go fuck off, so she stopped bothering us about that.
But. Yeah. I just went to hotsaucevault.com. I hadn't been here in a while. And this is on the really, really hot, hottest of the hot sauces. Here are some of their hot sauces. Da Bomb, the final answer hot sauce, hottest extract. Or is it Nuck and Futs hot sauce?
What movie is that from?
Blair's Beyond Death hot sauce. Smack My Ass and Call Me Sally hot sauce.
See, I wish I liked hot sauce.
See, I'd buy that one just because it says Smack My Ass and Call Me Sally hot sauce.
Do they have very mild?
Ass Blister hot sauce.
Yeah, I don't want an ass blister, so which would happen if I ate that hot sauce.
This is awesome. That's hot sauce talk. HotSauceVault.com.
Do they have like super mild like...
They got mild hot sauce. They got bacon hot sauce. Holy shit, habanero hot sauce. Love it.
I tried that ghost pepper shit one time.
Mm-hmm.
I ate damn near a gallon of ice cream. And it was like still chugging burned. Soda. And I was like, I can't get... I mean, my eyes were burning.
Blair's Heat Jalapeno... trying to be funny. Blair's Heat Jalapeno Tequila Hot Sauce.
Ooh, that sounds fun.
Blair's Heat Wasabi Green Tea Hot Sauce.
Ooh, that'd be gone. Fish tacos.
Blair's Pure Death Hot Sauce with Jolakaya. Jolakaya, I don't know.
That thing.
So I want to buy some of these hot sauces just because Old Fart Hot Sauce.
That's Alan. Yeah, I don't know. If it's spicier than a hot Cheeto, I can't eat it.
Oh, they got more. It's not just hot sauce.
Do they have salsa?
They got jerky. They got popcorn.
Oh, hell yeah.
Atomic Fireball candy. Crazy Jerry's Backfire X-Hot Oyster Sauce.
Mm.
Crazy Jerry's Boot Scootin' Garlic Mushrooms. This is awesome.
I want to be the guy that sits around and creates these names all day.
I mean, okay, I'm going to become a fan here. We're going to like this. And
do they have salsas?
Oh, let's see if they have salsas. Salsa, salsa, salsa. Your party starts here.
Mm, I do love me some salsa.
Crazy Uncle Jester's Habanero Pepper Jelly.
No, Negro, please.
Jack's Ass Salsa with Adjustable Heat Packet.
That's hilarious.
This is awesome. Crazy Jerry's Margarita No Sweat Salsa with Tequila.
Yeah, sign mama up.
We could just... this is crazy. Cajun Gourmet's Raspberry Salsa. Ooh. That sounds good. Pineapple Salsa.
Pineapple Salsa is good. So is Mango... Mango. I can't talk. Mango Salsa. Actually, some of the best salsa I had ever was at a farmer's market in Utah.
Cajun's Gourmet Mango Burst Salsa.
Mango salsa is super good.
Okay. I want to apologize.
If you like baked chicken and then sprinkle some of it on there?
I want to apologize to hotsaucevault.com. I briefly browsed your webpage when you first became a sponsor, and I apologize. I'm going to be a freaking customer because this is amazing. Zesty blue crab salsa. Mm. Have to eat crab just to have it.
I love crab.
Oh, they even got gag gifts. Barbecue sauces. Hold the phone.
Next slapping time you do ribs.
Slapping fat bacon ketchup.
What?
Dude, this is awesome. Anchor Bar Honey barbecue wing sauce. Oh, we haven't fed the dogs yet, have we? Oh, those poor dogs. Bone-sucking rib rub hot seasoning. That'll be my next ribs right there.
While you keep talking about delicious barbecue sauces that will feed the animals.
Oh, this is great.
Danny Blaze out.
Danny Blaze out. See you next week.
I will let everyone know when the 3-FAP is available for purchase, because I know most of these listeners that are men will be buying it. Don't act like you won't.
I tell you, hotsaucevault.com, I'm just going to donate the rest of this time here because this is an amazing, amazing variety. And you can sign in. You get yourself in here. What's your story? Our mission is simple, to provide the best products and service to our customers at the lowest prices possible. We take great pride in our company, our commitment to customer service, and the products we sell. Our online store is designed to provide you a safe and secure environment to browse our product and catalog. 25 years, our business background has brought us to the pinnacle of success by making sure that pleasing you, the customer, is our ultimate goal. I'm sold. This is going to happen. This is going to happen. They got barbecue sauces, party gift idea. They got a bunch of stuff. Go to hotsaucevault.com. HOTSAUCEVAULT.com. And I apologize. I should have been here sooner. I know I love hot sauce. I was going to stop by. I'm glad I did it live on the air. I hope you understand. Well, you don't understand. You know, hold my feet to the fire. Matter of fact, write an angry letter because this looks amazing. Black Mamba Extreme Hot Sauce. We got to get some of this in my body. And you know what I'm noticing about all these prices? They're all under $20. Well, there's a couple that are over $20. Pure Cap Hawk Sauce Extract looks like it comes in an eyedropper. That's how hot that is. Oh, my God. This is crazy. And you can register and just keep ordering. Well, I tell you what, this has been a great show. Thank you for joining us tonight. It has been a blast. Big things coming up. You can hear me live on KMAC Sports. I'll be doing the play-by-play for the Manor Mustangs versus the Elgin Wildcats for Elgin. It's their home game. two good teams in the division that our Hutto Hippos play, both these teams. So they'll be seeing these teams later on. So I want to thank my son Alex for coming in, filling in at the last minute. Talk about some guns, and hopefully we got some good information about that. Chuck Licata of KMAC Sports joining myself and Joe Pardini. Talking sports and football. We got your picks in. Hopefully you wrote those down, and we'll be discussing those next week. And also Miss Danny Blaze, and I cannot forget the incomparable, the beautiful, the lovely Blanche Beauregard, who called in. And she's always welcome to call in or come in. She's an amazingly beautiful woman. We'd love to have her a part of the show. All right, folks, that's it for me. For all of us here at Armed Radio Global Central Texas Man Cave, I'm Mike Allen. We'll see you next week, 9 p.m. Central Standard Time. And hopefully we'll get this fixed. We'll be on the other platform because I figured out why that doesn't work. So we'll get that fixed. Okay, take care. Go Lions. We'll see you next week. I'm Mike Allen. This is the Armed Radio Global Network, and you have been on the air.